all bets are off.
Twenty-nine minutes past the hour. Welcome back to Wake Up with Al.
It's Friday. You ain't got no job. You got nothing to do.
That's also September 25th.
Yeah, it is that too. We have NASA joining us in just a few minutes to talk about a rare event, a supermoon, total lunar eclipse. When it goes down, what we're going to see.
Who has the best chance of seeing?
Yeah, how will it affect your heart?
All right. Excuse me?
Total eclipse of the heart. I don't know. It didn't work.
Well, we've got this coastal low, heavy rain, wind, high surf, rip currents. It is going to be a mess. And some of this rain, some areas could see up to 7 inches of rain. So we're going to be watching that. Also, fall warmth hanging around coast to coast. We are looking at some warmth, especially out west. Boise, Salt Lake, Las Vegas, Denver, all seeing very warm conditions. And we're watching the Gulf for early next week. Could be something developing. There's a lot of shear also it's got to fight, but at best, really, nothing happens, but at worst, it brings a lot of rain, so we're going to be watching that as well, Steph.
Those wind barbs, they just get me every time I see them. All right, let's talk about the flooding concerns mounting in coastal North Carolina this morning. Here's the scene from Nag's Head yesterday. Large waves washing ashore all stemmed from that disturbance along the East Coast, and we could see some significant erosion here. Now, I just retweeted a picture. It was from, Kitty Hawk? Kitty Hawk or Kill Devil Hills? I can't remember off the top of my head. I just retweeted it real quick. Significant erosion. It was literally the road, and then it drops like 4 or 5 feet just straight down like that. So if you want to see it, go to my Twitter. It's just Stephanie Abrams. You can see it. It's because we have this east flow right now, okay? So here's the rain coming in North Carolina, South Carolina, but the poor beaches here, the Outer Banks, very typical, though, that you see significant erosion, even just during low-pressure events like this. So I always say the atmosphere is like a hamburger. Now, this is what's happening in the tomato layer. We've been talking a lot about the surface low that's just about here, but you see the spin right here, that's the upper level low. So we actually have two lows that we are following here, and this is what is causing all of the nasty weather that we have into the southeast. Now, onshore flow is not only because of our surface low, but also because of a high pressure off to the northeast. That has a clockwise flow, low pressure counterclockwise flow. So right in between these two, you have an extra push onto the coast. So it's just like if you put your finger over a hose, the water is going to squirt out faster. Well, the winds are going to be stronger and you're going to have more erosion here. We need the rain. So this is actually a good thing. I know because things, they don't happen exactly when you want them to. It seems like a bad thing, but it's always good in the end, right? And we are seeing the good stuff right here into the Carolinas. We could see very heavy rainfall into eastern North Carolina, also moving up into Virginia as well, all the way through our Monday forecast. So Wilmington, we are going to see some showers and storms here, and our temperatures are going to stay on the cool side, due in part, Al, because that upper low, which is a cold pocket, and that's why Atlanta's only going to be 65, because cold air wants to drop, and so it does, and we get cooler temperatures.
That's why everybody likes Hot Pockets.
What's your favorite flavor Hot Pocket, though?
Pizza. Okay, we're looking at a beautiful fall day in St. Louis. Sunrise expected about 20 minutes. We're looking at temperatures warmer than average, getting into the 80s. So that's going to be awfully nice. Let's show you what we've got right now. Marquette, 58. Chicago, 60. Same in Indianapolis, 62. North Platte, Minneapolis, you're coming in at 65 degrees. All right, there's that area that Steph was talking about, that cool upper level low. But the ridge is going to be pushing that jet stream up. And look at that. Rest of the country stays pretty warm. Above average highs for a lot of locations. Salt Lake, Billings, Denver, Chicago, even Buffalo. Above average temperatures. Today our highs, Des Moines, 7 degrees above average at 80 degrees. 75 Chicago, 86 in St. Louis. Now you cool down a bit in St. Louis tomorrow. Chicago still warm. Des Moines at 80 degrees. And then Sunday, North Platte, 83. Still warm in Minneapolis. 11 degrees above average, 78. Chicago, you're going to be at 76 degrees. St. Louis, your average high, 76, which you are at tomorrow, but then by Monday you warm up to 86 degrees.
So we're not finished with summer just yet, and we are warm in the west as well, thanks to the fires. Good news though in California as crews gain containment of some of the state's largest wildfires.
That's right. There's a fire burning in Monterey County, sparked up 6 days ago. It's now 94% contained.
That's good. Meanwhile, the Valley Fire, we've been talking about that one for a long time now, 87% contained. That fire is responsible for 4 deaths, injuring 4 firefighters, and destroying more more than 1,900 structures.
Firefighters also getting a better handle on the Butte Fire. Two people died in that blaze. Also destroyed more than 400 homes. 91% containment being reported.
Well, a Florida man is counting his blessings today. The father of four was struck by lightning while working at a construction site last week, and he says it nearly ended his life.
Floyd Patterson helping load blocks on a roof, the boxer, when a bolt of lightning hit a nearby crane. He says he was in and out of consciousness until taken to the hospital, aside from headaches and some pain in his arm. Mr. Patterson says he escaped relatively
unharmed. Whoa, look at his pants.
Man.
That I can't even fathom what that is like, and I hope I never do. Look at the kisses there and the cheeks on that thing.
Good-looking guy.
Who doesn't want to just dive into a baby's cheeks like that? All right, let's have a look at where we are going to see the sunshine today. Lots of light here, Little Rock, Oklahoma, Albuquerque, on into San Angelo. Some thunderstorms perhaps down into Brownsville. What's interesting is they always say they have to worry about like golfers and stuff, but that's not really the case. It's more people that do construction that get struck by lightning, or perhaps like people that do landscaping, because they always make the golfers come off the course. They send out the signal and everyone has to come off. Fishermen also watch out for that when you're out on the boat. So here into the Northeast, another spectacular day. It's going to be phenomenal here. Anywhere from Boston, a little bit on the cooler side, all the way down into the nation's capital. Boston, 65 again. That east wind makes you a little bit cooler. Al?
Looking good. All right, Steph. Well, it's a rare celestial event, a lunar eclipse that coincides with a supermoon. So what does it mean and where can you view it? NASA's got the answer. They're coming up next. Let's look right now at the active radar, and you can see all that wet weather spinning around that upper level low and that low pressure off the coast.
Yeah, so here we go. The heavier showers just coming in. This is going to continue through the day today, and it doesn't really move a whole lot.
Yeah.
So it stays kind of in the same locations.
And we take a look live right now in beautiful Atlanta.
Yeah, 65 is all we're going to see today. Look at that, clouds and showers. You can thank that upper level low for all of this mess, and I bet some big flight delays too.
Ew.
Americans drink 48 billion bottles of water every year. That's enough plastic bottles to stretch around the earth 230 times. Each Brita filter can replace 300 of those. Clean, clear Brita water. Nothing is better.
Baby girl.
Duracell Quantum lasts longer in 99% of devices, so you can always be there.
You tuck here. You tuck there. If you're a toe tucker because of toenail fungus, ask your doctor now about prescription keratin. Used daily, keratin drops may kill the fungus at the site of infection and get to the root of your toe tucking. Keratin may cause irritation at the treated site. Most common side effects include skin peeling, ingrown toenail, redness, itching, and swelling. Tell your doctor if you have any side effect that bothers you or does not go away. Stop toe tucking and get the drop on toenail fungus. Ask your doctor today about keratin.
At Intel, they make technology that gives you the power of a PC and fun of a tablet.
I could turn it into a tablet and do my spreadsheets.
I said fun of a tablet?
Exactly.
Upgrade to a 2-in-1 with Intel Inside.
If the Dodge brothers walked into a dealership today, they'd be pretty impressed with what's become of their Maverick car company. With all the power, performance, and ingenuity. Knowing them, they'd insist on serving the donuts. Get yours before their history.
We thought we'd be ready, but demand for our cocktail bitters was huge. I could feel our deadlines racing towards us. We didn't need a loan. We needed short-term funding, fast. Our Amex helped us fill the orders, just like that. You can't predict it, but you can be ready.
Another step on the journey. Will you be ready when growth presents itself? Realize your buying power at open.com.
Trick or treat! Thank you!
Let's tap into new floors in a new way. Step up the savings and get moving. Yeah, like that. Let's do this. Get Pergo Haley Oak Laminate for just $2.29 a square foot. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
Heartburn comes creeping up on you. Fight back with relief so smooth and fast. Tums Smoothie starts dissolving the instant it touches your tongue and neutralizes stomach acid at the source. Smoothies, only from Tums.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Tonight, cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Winds light and variable. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Morning past the hour. Good morning, Tampa. You're waking up to temperatures this morning in the upper 70s. Going to get up to about 89 with chances of afternoon thunderstorm.
That we are. And do you know that vitamin B12 is actually found in rain?
Did not know that.
I didn't either. At the ocean's deepest point, the water pressure is equivalent of having 50 jumbo jets piled up on top of you.
Those are two very disparate facts. But
they are, but they're both water-related. That's the connection, I think.
Yeah.
All right, so we've got the rain and we've got the water here, right?
And we've got the question mark.
Yeah.
Is there some development? I've never seen that one. We never learned that one in meteorology. So Monday, we've got some heavy rain along the Gulf, and Tuesday, it spreads on up into the mid-Mississippi River Valley.
Yeah, that's one of those showers and thunderstorm events that lasts all the way through our Tuesday, so it's going to be staying unsettled regardless of if this thing is named or not.
And as you take a look at your Tampa forecast, here we go. Looking ahead through Tuesday, we've got scattered showers and thunderstorms from Sunday to Tuesday. All right, how about a little drive here?
Let's do it. Our DDI, or Driving Difficulty Index. We're going to take you from Birmingham onto Atlanta, Charlotte, into Raleigh, and this is where you're going to see on and off showers. So if you don't have good windshield wipers, you're going to have the schmear. It's going to be annoying. If you don't have good tires, you have to watch for spin outs. So maybe a good time to get everything new on your car.
That's right. You want your own driving forecast? Go to weather.com/DDI. Okay, so fall may be just days old, but preparations already underway in Boston to avoid a repeat of the massive problems they experienced last year.
Yeah, that record-breaking snowfall. The affiliate from our affiliate, NECN.
This is the new third rail.
The governor and the MBTA's general manager inspecting some of the T's new third rail. Nearly 10 miles of it should be in place on the orange and red lines before the first snow of the season.
I feel very good that we are far better prepared for this winter than we were last year.
Governor Baker and other transportation types visited this T yard in Dorchester to talk about what's being done to avoid the same kinds of problems the T experienced during last year's historic winter. In all, $85 million has been invested in the off-season to make sure the subways and commuter trains are more reliable for the winter of 2015.
We're preparing for winter just like last one, and our team is being trained for that. We're being equipped for that.
The new third rail, which will improve electrical connections, is only part of the fix. Switchers on the tracks will be heated to keep them from freezing, and trains on the orange and red lines will be outfitted with plows. The MBTA is also stepping up the way it tackles storms and plans to improve communications with passengers when the snow starts falling.
We'll get to North Quincy by early December.
The effort to reassure people about the T's performance this winter comes one day after a financial control board said the T's finances are unsustainable. I asked the T's general manager if he can guarantee his customers that this winter will be better than the last.
I guarantee, otherwise he fires me.
Specifics. All right, let's have a look at your 7-day forecast here. And as we look at it, we don't have any snow in the forecast, which is good news so far, except for all you skiers and snowboarders out there. You're like, Abrams, that's bad news. We want snow. And you got a little tease as we showed you, you know, pictures and videos on social media and on the network here of different ski resorts kind of firing up their snowmaking machines. They were just testing them out, though. The heat will be a big story. Billings also into Los Angeles. Hotter there than Atlanta, also into Miami. Atlanta, you're cool because this upper-level low. Cold air wants to sink. It's going to be doing that. And we also have the clouds and the showers. But we rebound on Sunday. Maybe you have a kickball tournament going on Sunday. That's always fun to do. Showers are going to be moving up the coast. I don't, do kids even still play kickball? Because I feel, oh, they do? Okay, that's good to know. I'm glad that that is not lost. We will see major changes in our temperatures. Minneapolis and Chicago, essentially right around 80 degrees. But we drop down into the 60s. So in a 24-hour period, you are going to get a shock to the system here in Minneapolis. Chicago, the same for you, but it comes in on your Wednesday. That's when you see the 60s. 59 we dip into Minneapolis and onto our Thursday forecast. Again, cooler air will continue to spread to the east.
Actually, adult kickball leagues, very big now.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about. I was mentioning Atlanta. I was wondering if kids still play it or if they've gotten rid of it.
That's right. Well, from beach erosion and storms off the mid-Atlantic coast to an area of development in the Gulf.
Yes, we are tracking the tropical activity closely, plus two forecasters in the right place at the right time.
That's right. Capturing this dust devil.
Woo. It's pretty big.
Yeah, that's right. They were up a little closer to it before they finally realized we ought to get away from this.
Yeah, thing. They did.
Let's take a look right now live in Chicago. Hello, Chicago. Hello. Beautiful Michigan Avenue.
I love when you catch all the lights like that and you just go straight through. Boom. Such a good feeling.
This driving difficulty index brought to you by Subaru. Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
Making the most out of every mile. That's why I got a Subaru Impreza.
Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
I asked my dentist if an electric toothbrush was going to clean better than a manual. He said sure, but don't get just anyone. Get one inspired by dentists with a round brush head.
Go pro with Oral-B. Oral-B's rounded brush head cups your teeth to break up plaque and rotates to sweep it away. And Oral-B delivers a clinically proven superior clean versus Sonicare Diamond Clean.
My mouth feels super clean.
Oral-B. Know you're getting a superior clean.
I'm never going back to a manual brush.
Everest is the movie event like nothing you have experienced.
Let's go! Get out there! I need help! Get up!
I'm not leaving you behind.
Everest. Rated PG-13.
AT&T and DirecTV are now one, which means you can watch movies while you're on the move, sitcoms while you sit on those, and even Fargo in Fargo. Binge while you lose weight and enjoy a good cliffhanger while you hang from a Why Am I Yelling? The revolution will not only be televised, the revolution will be mobilized. Introducing the all-in-one plan, only from DirecTV and AT&T.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the web.
Before Mars, before space stations, before shuttles, before one small step, before rocket rides, before flat tops, freeze-dried, and flight suits, back when what went up still had to come down, we challenged ourselves to change everything. A first-person view of space awaits at the spot where our journey to the heavens began. Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex. Always exploring.
Bahamas Paradise Cruise Line wants you to sail away with us. So we're offering an amazing cruise rate of just $109. Your two-night Bahamas cruise includes five-course dining, amazing live shows, lots of fun on the ship, and more fun in the Bahamas. For just $109, you can't say no to the best cruise to the Bahamas. What are you waiting for? Call 800-814-7100. That's 800-814-7100.
This kind of weather, all bets are off.
Come on, Jimmy!
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Tonight, cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Winds light and variable. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Just about 50 minutes past the hour, so that means it's time for our tropical update.
Yes, and our hurricane specialist Michael Lowry is standing by. Michael, this low pressure in the Gulf.
The question mark.
The question mark. But I think what we're looking at right now on the East Coast is really kind of a good indicator of why it doesn't matter if this thing is named or not. The erosion is significant in the Outer Banks.
It is, Stephanie, and that's a good point, is that it doesn't take an organized tropical system to cause problems, and we've seen that really this year with these, I would call them nuisance lows, but they've had impacts in terms of their erosion and the rainfall and everything that you would really get from a tropical system, except for really the strong winds. Take a look at what we have here off the East Coast. It's a big sordid mess. Stephanie, to steal a line from you, drop your bagel, grab your cinnamon roll. If you look at the water vapor picture, that's kind of what it looks like today. We have this nice big upper level spin here over the southeast U.S. This is not at the surface. You're looking about 15 or 20,000 feet up in the atmosphere. But what that upper level feature is doing is it's drawing all of this juicy tropical air northward into the Carolinas, into the southeast U.S. Now, at the same time, we do have a surface area of low pressure just off the coast here. And it's that difference between low pressure down here to the south and high pressure to the north that's creating that really brisk onshore flow. The winds aren't quite as bad as they were yesterday here along the East Coast. But Norfolk, wind gust to 24 miles per hour, so not all that shabby. This low pressure system not expected to develop. It's going to move inland today, weaken as it does so. And then another area of low pressure is going to set up here off the coast of the Carolinas come tomorrow and into Sunday. And that's what's really going to cause the coastal problems there through the mid-Atlantic states through this weekend. So unfortunately, the mess there, there in the Outer Banks and up through the lower Chesapeake Basin, it's going to stay there at least for a few days, but no tropical, organized tropical development there, but still some problems. Elsewhere in the tropics, Tropical Depression 6C formed here in the Central Pacific Ocean. This one, it's going to kind of move toward Hawaii, but not affect them. It's going to weaken and move a little bit to the south. Let's talk about the Gulf of Mexico, though. This is an interesting scenario that's sort of setting up for early next week. 1 in 5 chance of development here as it moves toward the north and toward the Gulf of Mexico. Not expecting any development here in the Western Caribbean, but once it gets over the Gulf, conditions maybe a little more favorable for some sort of tropical or even subtropical type development. You can trace this rainfall. It's going to move across the Yucatan Peninsula. Land should prohibit any development, at least in the short term. But once it gets over the Gulf, pretty confident we'll have some sort of low pressure feature sitting there. But the upper level winds are so strong that anything that we get is going to be a big, messy system. Not expecting a huge, you know, a strong tropical storm or a hurricane. Could get a tropical system out of this, but rainfall, the big story along the Gulf Coast Monday and Tuesday. Alan, step back to you.
All right, we'll be watching that. Thanks so much, Michael. Well, check this out. Not your ordinary dust devil.
Two forecasters with the National Weather Service office in Louisiana captured this video yesterday.
Okay, so watch as this dust devil grows in size and continues to grow. This just outside Floyd, Louisiana.
Yeah, in a matter of minutes it disappears. But that's a pretty big one, I'll say, for a dust devil size.
Yeah, I saw this video. There was some video where they were actually closer to it.
Yeah.
And then they start backing away and get to that point.
It's on their Facebook page. All right, coming up next, it's a football-filled weekend ahead, and we have your game day forecast.
Looking for a delicious dinner idea? Make tonight White Chicken Chili Night. Start with Bush's white chili beans, simmered in our flavorful chili sauce. Then add rotisserie chicken. Punch it up with a little heat. And a few ingredients from your pantry. It's easy to make the perfect pot of chili every time. Make your chili better with Bush's White Chili Beans. For this and more great chili recipes, visit bushbeans.com.
When is your flu shot more than a flu shot? When it helps give a life-saving vaccine to a child in need in a developing country. Thanks to customers like you, Walgreens Get a Shot, Give a Shot program has helped provide 7 million vaccines. Make your flu shot make a world of difference. Walgreens, at the corner of happy and healthy.
You see this look on my face? That's not anger, that's hunger. So I'm gonna have a snack to make me feel better. And once I do, you'll see a look of satisfaction and contentment blossom across my face. See? Now I feel better. Make your tummy happy. Your play.
Americans drink 48 billion bottles of water every year. That's enough plastic bottles to stretch around the Earth 230 times. Each Brita filter can replace 300 of those. Clean, clear Brita water. Nothing is better.
I've got two reasons to take care of my heart. That's why I take Meta.
Meta is clinically proven to help lower cholesterol. Try Meta today. And for a tasty, heart-healthy snack, try a Meta Health Bar.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
55 past the hour. Good morning, Indianapolis. Your temperature's in the upper 50s this morning. You're going to see partly cloudy skies as the kids head out the door for the school bus coming home. Partly sunny and a temperature about 81 degrees. Hey, if you're having a little toast this morning, consider this. Wonder Bread of Indianapolis, the first company to widely commercialize the best invention ever,
sliced bread. People say, why was sliced bread such a big deal? Imagine every time you're going to get a piece of bread.
You have to slice it.
You have to slice it.
That's
right. I mean, you were there when we did the changeover from not having sliced bread to sliced bread. What was that like, Roker?
It was fantastic. When we used to toast it over an open fire,
yeah.
It was fantastic. Scattered showers in Atlanta for the kids coming home. And then as we go to Philadelphia for your bus stop, we are looking at a beautiful morning, some clouds and 65 and 75 and cloudy on the way home. And then finally we end up in Charlotte.
Yes, the Queen City. Temperatures are cold here, due in part to that upper level low and the cloud cover and the showers.
Hey, we got some new colorful pictures of Pluto this morning. High resolution images show a wide array of colors and varying terrain on the dwarf planet.
A mountain range on Pluto's surface appears gray and blue. Its jagged ridge created what scientists have described as a snake skin like appearance.
Wow, another image shows colors ranging from brown to white and shades in between. Images were captured by the New Horizons spacecraft on July.
Does it blow anybody else's mind that we are all the way at Pluto taking these pictures, sending them back, and how crystal clear? I mean, like,
that's amazing.
Does everyone else appreciate this?
It's mind boggling.
It's amazing. All right, you know what else is amazing? It's college football Saturday. Yeah, boy. Michigan, with the new coach and everything, you think we'd get a little help there, but it's been a rough start here for Michigan. Look at this. BYU is ranked 22, top 25, Al. Michigan isn't, and they're a powerhouse.
I have no idea what that means.
Okay, they are going to see a great weather, though, for the game there. Otherwise, it's going to be very wet. Georgia Tech, big, sad loss last weekend. That was a rough one against Notre Dame, against the Duke Blue Devils, that's what is coming out. And then my Florida Gators, this is a huge matchup, especially since Tennessee was ranked, and now they're not in the top 25 anymore. And I remember all preseason, I'm like, how are they ranked? What's going on here? So this should be a very good game. Showers and thunderstorms in the swamp and the 80s.
But neither team ranked.
Neither team ranked, but it will still be a good matchup.
All righty. Well, got lots more coming up in the Power Hour. Wake Up with Al. East Coast getting a wet start to the weekend.
That's right. It's all in a minute.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Tonight, cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Winds light and variable. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
This morning on Wake Up With Al, rain, flooding, and rip currents all possible as a pair of systems hammer the East Coast. Where the conditions mirror that of a tropical storm heading into the weekend.
Plus, fall is here, bringing pumpkin spice and college football, but many parts of the country are in for a bit of a warm-up. We're going to show you where the temperatures are rising right here, right now on Wake Up With Al.
Hey, good morning, everybody. Friday, September 25, 2015. Welcome back to Wake Up With Al.
I haven't heard someone say that. September 25. I like that. I'm Stephanie Abrams alongside Al Roker, and we're going to get you started with Al's top three.
That's right. Everything you need to know as you head into the weekend. First of all, if you're in the southeast, watch out. You've got some coastal troubles. And even as far north as Long Island, rip currents are going to be a big problem. But as you get into the southeast, heavy rain, wind, probably going to be airport delays. Steph mentioned in Atlanta, high surf and rip currents. Number two, we've got coast-to-coast fall warmth, especially out west, where temperatures could be anywhere from 10 to almost 20 degrees above normal. But even into New England, Burlington, 11 degrees above normal. And we are watching the Gulf for some sort of development. May not become a tropical system, but you don't need an AIM storm to be plenty of problems. Heavy rain possible, lots of wind. We're going to be watching it from New Orleans all the way to Tallahassee, Steph.
Okay, so let's talk about the first low pressure along the East Coast, because that one is causing significant erosion and a lot of rainfall as well. Let's go to Topsail Beach in North Carolina, where high surf is definitely a hazard. Yesterday, the beach just getting pounded, and that was an issue in the water and out of the water as well. We're talking erosion, and we're also talking rip current. The worst conditions today are going to happen really from now all the way into the evening hours. We're going to see more erosion. I just retweeted a picture that literally shows the highway, and it's just like road and then just drops off significantly. Some significant erosion there. So here's the surface low pressure. Remember, we were talking about that upper level low pressure over Atlanta. That's why it's going to be so cold today, because we have that upper level low. But this low pressure is causing that oomph, causing that lift along the coast. And listen, we always want things to happen how we want them to happen, right? There's a great quote that says everything works out in the end. So if it hasn't worked out, it's not the end yet.
Who said that?
I don't know who said that.
Okay.
But it's one of my most favorite quotes, because it's a good thing to remember that just because we're getting the rain onto the weekend, we're like, we don't want it to be like that. But this is a good thing. And in the end, this is actually all going to be great, because we have drought conditions here under the Carolinas. So we'll take the rain, but we want to take it out of the water because of the rip current threat that's going to be happening really from portions of the northeast all the way down to the southeast. Very strong winds, because high pressure to the north, low pressure to the south, the winds are getting squeezed in between those two. So that's what's causing the rip current and also the erosion. So here's the rain for you. Again, still very dry through the Carolinas. We'll get the heaviest rain, though, along the border here of Virginia and also in North Carolina. Basically, the rain's going to be like riding a horse, and it's just going to be straddling the border right there. And that's where we are going to see the showers. Oranges means we could see over 5 inches. But Al, a really big area of 3 to 5 here.
All right, who said I am what I am?
I don't know.
Popeye.
He's so profound.
Okay. Is this in fact Dallas? I want to make sure, because I'm not sure that
it is.
Okay, I just want to double check, because there's another. I think Charleston has that green building too. Anyway, 73 degrees right now. You're going to get up to 92 degrees. Hey, guess what? Texas State Fair kicks off. It's all about the food this year. Milk chocolate, bacon on a stick, and sausage and pepper jack cheese on a stick. There ain't nothing you can't make better than by frying it and putting it on a stick. Let me tell you, that's good eating. All right, here you go. Dallas, every day this month, you've had high temperatures that have been at least 86 degrees. Only other time there have been no highs below 85 was back in September 1910, when they invented the stick that they use at the state fair to put everything else on. Right now it's 74 in Dallas, 72 Houston, 65 Jackson, Little Rock looking at 66 degrees. And here's how we're going to set up this warmth. I mean, we've got that big ridge of high pressure, jet streams to the north. We've got that cool upper low over the southeast. But you can see everywhere else it's going to stay fairly warm, almost from coast to coast, right on into New England. So on Under the weekend, Salt Lake City, Billings, Denver, Chicago, Buffalo, St. Louis, anywhere from 5 to 15 degrees or more higher. For today, Dallas will be at 92, Houston 91, Nashville 75. Then for tomorrow, Little Rock 83, Houston 91, 91 in Dallas. And moving ahead towards Sunday, stays fairly warm, cools off a little bit in Houston and there along New Orleans. And here's your forecast for Dallas, average high 85. You don't get anywhere near that. Closest you get is on Monday with a temperature about 89.
All right, time now for your headlines, and we want to talk about that tornado in Charleston. The National Weather Service investigating a likely tornado near Charleston, South Carolina overnight. There were reports of downed trees and also some homes. Did he say 10 homes in that interview?
Yeah, 10 homes.
Got damaged.
Yeah, that's right. Radar indicating a likely tornado in the West Ashley and Johns Island area. Shortly after the storm passed, residents gathered to help clean up debris. No injuries reported. Still a flash flood watch out there until 8 a.m. this morning, Steph.
You know what, Al? You know what I've got a pocket full of right here?
Miracles.
Sunshine. Ah, thank you, Ann. Yes, I've got a pocket full of sunshine.
Who
I'm going to throw it. There's a song. I got a pocket full of sunshine. Yes, Natasha Bedingfield. Thank you. That's who sang that. Anyhow, I'm going to take this fake pocket and sunshine and throw it into the Midwest, and it's just going to splatter across all the cities here. Look at that. From Cleveland all the way over into Minneapolis, also into Kansas City. We've got it here, and it's going to be going strong in Indianapolis with a high of 83 degrees, still warm for this time of year. And we're going to take our other pocket full of sunshine and throw it into the Northeast. And Al, when you don't have pockets, girls, you know, we stick things in other areas to hold things.
Mm-hmm. The state of our climate, it's taking center stage today thanks to Pope Francis. Up next, a preview of what the pontiff is going to say in his address to the United Nations later this morning.
If the Dodge brothers walked into a dealership today, they'd be pretty impressed with what's become of their Maverick car company. With all the power, performance, and ingenuity. But knowing them, they'd insist on serving the donuts. Get yours before their history.
Now, let's talk about Lancaster. Classic caramel reimagined into buttery rich creams. So surprisingly soft, they melt in your mouth while you sit back and say,
wow.
Lancaster, caramel reimagined.
Did you know that meeting your daily protein needs actually helps to support your muscle health? Boost High Protein Nutritional Drink can help you get the protein you need. Each serving has 15 grams of protein to help maintain muscle, plus 26 vitamins and minerals, including calcium and vitamin D, to support strong bones. Boost High Protein is the number one selling high protein complete nutritional drink, and it has a great taste, guaranteed. Help get the nutrition you need every day with Boost High Protein, available at these fine retailers.
Let's do installation. Let's check out one of these to make this easier to tackle. Because the more we bundle up here, the less we need to hear. Let's do this. Get AutoCAD insulation for just $29.68. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
Matt's gotten used to the funk in his man cave. Yep, he's gone nose blind. He thinks it smells fine, but his wife smells this. Luckily for all your hard-to-wash fabrics, there's Febreze Fabric Refresher. Febreze doesn't just mask, it eliminates odors you've gone nose blind to. Break out the Febreze and breathe happy.
Make a wish!
Who wants cake?
She does.
Get your flu shot at Rite Aid today. Because your coworkers didn't.
If you're taking multiple medications, does your mouth often feel dry? A dry mouth can be a side effect of many medications, but it can also lead to tooth decay and bad breath. That's why there's Biotene. Available as an oral rinse, toothpaste, spray, or gel, Biotene can provide soothing relief, and it helps keep your mouth healthy, too. Remember, while your medication is doing you good, a dry mouth isn't. Biotene, for people who suffer from a dry mouth.
That was unexpected.
But you always know exactly what to expect when you have Amica Auto Insurance.
Personal attention and great service every time you call.
Call for a free quote now. You can save up to 15% when you combine auto and home insurance with Amica. Remember, the unexpected can always happen. So call Amica and expect great service every time.
This kind of weather, all bets are off.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Tonight, cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Winds light and variable. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Good can't come of it.
I can handle myself.
Blind Spot, new this Monday after The Voice on NBC. And get the app.
10 minutes past the hour. Good morning, Houston. You got a mostly cloudy day ahead for you with temperatures getting near 90.
Probably a good day to take a tour of the Port of Houston aboard the MV Sam Houston. And it's free as long as you have a reservation.
And enjoy the nice weather while it lasts, because looking like we could be looking at a lot of wet weather going into the
weekend.
And it's going
to cool off in Houston, yeah. Too.
That's right.
I mean, so, not like significantly.
But. Yeah. So we got this system developing. Does it become tropical? Doesn't really matter whether it does or not.
No, it's going to bring the same results regardless. So we will see some showers here along I-10, I-20, spreading northbound. It sticks around all the way really through our Tuesday. So more clouds and more showers, some drenching rain, but we need it here.
Yeah, look at some areas of extreme drought in eastern Texas, on into northern Louisiana, parts of central Mississippi. And so here's the rainfall amounts we're expecting out of this. Well, generally about 1 to 2 inches, every little bit helps. And your Houston 3-day forecast.
Here we go. We are going to see those temperatures hang in the 80s, as we said, on Monday's going to dip a little bit, but we rebound on Tuesday.
Well, Pope Francis is in the middle of his groundbreaking tour of America this morning. Pope expected to address the United Nations, when we'll hear more about his plan to help combat climate change.
Joining us this morning to discuss is Michael Lemonick from Climate Central. Michael, thanks for being with us. We love when you're on the show. When the Pope addressed Congress, he never mentioned climate change by name. So why not say those two words?
Well, I would not presume to say what was in the Pope's mind. It might well be that he doesn't want to be too much in people's face. He was pretty much in it anyway with his remarks about climate change at other venues during this trip. So he may have just been being polite, but nobody doubted what he was talking about.
And then this morning, he's at the UN.
Right.
What do we expect? Do we expect he's going to actually address climate change and perhaps even use those words?
Well, again, you know, I don't have the Pope's confidence, but I think he has been talking about it very clearly. Whatever words he does or doesn't use, and I fully expect him to do it again. He doesn't have to worry about offending Republicans. At the UN today.
How has his message been received? By the way, do either of you know, I didn't even check, did that congressman really boycott the speech? I missed if that really happened or not. I don't know either.
Nobody cares.
Yeah, I don't either.
I don't either. But okay, so regardless, how is it being received? Because it seemed like both parties stood up and clapped for him.
Yeah, well, I mean, you can sit down and look stony-faced when the president of the opposite party is making the State of the Union speech, but you know, for the Pope, it would have been monumentally rude not to do that. So I don't think. Well, and I mean, the other thing is he talked about respect for life and people sure. who are opposed to abortion rights like his position on that. So everybody could find something to clap for mm-hmm. without, you know, looking foolish.
Michael, would you say that his message, or what have you heard, if his message is resonating with people?
I have. I think that a lot of people take it very seriously that such a beloved, actually, but also powerful spiritual leader is speaking out so explicitly about many things, about immigration, which is another, you know, another thing that he talked about, but also about climate change. And this is clearly the first time anyone with such spiritual power has done that. And many in the climate change community think that has the potential to do as much or more than anything Al Gore has ever said.
Wow. Well,
Michael, you always have such good insight.
Yeah,
I love
really
when you come on. So
Michael,
thanks.
Thank you so much. And just watching the Holy Father here in New York, I watched him last night. It's just so awe-inspiring on so many levels.
Yeah, it is. Well, it's time now for your 7-day forecast. And we're going to have a look at the start of today and the cool air into Atlanta. This is due in part to this upper level low that we have here. We also have a surface low here. And so that's what's causing some of our cooler temperatures, because an upper level low is a cold pocket aloft. So that's going to bring down some cooler air. We also have those clouds and showers, so that's going to make it a little bit cooler. Look at Billings in Los Angeles, 92 tomorrow, 87 in Miami. We're going to get through the weekend. Sunday, we see our temperatures start to cool off in Montana. But guess what? Watch what happens in the Midwest, Al. Tuesday into Wednesday, the 60s for Minneapolis and in Chicago. So we're trending more towards fall.
All right. Well, from beach erosion and storms off the mid-Atlantic coast to an area of development in the Gulf, we are tracking tropical activity close to home. And they say you got a better chance of winning the lotto than getting struck by lightning. How one man says he's done both. Wow. Talk about your luck. Right after your local on the 8th.
I asked my dentist if an electric toothbrush was going to clean better than a manual. He said sure, but don't get just anyone. Get one inspired by dentists with a round brush head.
Go pro with Oral-B. Oral-B's rounded brush head cups your teeth to break up plaque and rotates to sweep it away. And Oral-B delivers a clinically proven superior clean versus Sonicare Diamond Clean.
My mouth feels super clean.
Oral-B. Know you're getting a superior clean.
I'm never going back to a manual brush.
If you don't think Seize the Trip when you think AARP, then you don't know ARP. Get inspired with AARP Travel. Plan and book your trip online and get hot travel tips from the pros. Find more real possibilities at aarp.org/possibilities.
How about over there?
What does it mean to have an unlimited mileage warranty on a certified pre-owned Mercedes-Benz? What does it mean to drive as far as you want for up to 3 years and be covered? It means your odometer is there to record the memories. During the Mercedes-Benz Certified Pre-Owned Sales event, now through September 30th, you'll get complimentary prepaid maintenance and receive your first 2 months' payments on us, only at your authorized Mercedes-Benz dealer.
Lowe's presents How to Make Someone Disappear.
Stephanie, I love you!
How's that look?
Much better.
Now get 20% off in-stock Levalore faux wood blinds and cellular shades at Lowe's.
You tuck here, you tuck there. If you're a toe tucker because of toenail fungus, ask your doctor now about prescription keratin. Use daily keratin drops may kill the fungus at the site of infection and get to the root of your toe tucking. Keratin may cause irritation at the treated site. Most common side effects include skin peeling, ingrown toenail, redness, itching, and swelling. Tell your doctor if you have any side effect that bothers you or does not go away. Stop toe tucking and get the drop on toenail fungus. Ask your doctor today about keratin.
This kind of weather, all bets are off.
I just had a horrible nightmare. My company's entire network went down and I was home in bed unaware. But that would never happen. Comcast Business monitors my company's network 24 hours a day and calls and emails me of something like, this scary storm takes it offline, so I can rest easy. What, you don't have a desk bed?
Don't be left in the dark. Get proactive alerts 24/7.
Comcast Business, built for business.
Square is kind of like me, just plain and simple. You pay 2.75%, whether it's Amex, Visa, MasterCard, you can take them all. The Square reader makes the transaction so much easier and so much quicker. The other thing I like is how fast money is in your account. I mean, it's right away. It's probably one of the best moves I've ever made in business.
Accept all major credit cards with Square and get your money fast. Get started free at square.com.
$19.99. Weekdays on AMHQ.
I want to make sure everybody can get an idea of what's happening here.
Let's talk about that. Let's lift the base of this.
You're about to see something you have never seen on television before.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Tonight, cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Winds light and variable. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Just about 20 minutes past the hour, time for the tropical update.
We are going to head down to Atlanta and talk with our hurricane specialist, Michael Lowry. And Michael, you know, when it comes to tropics, really you just look a lot at like the surface low and then you want high pressure. But you're talking about upper level lows, which is kind of not, you know, go with tropics.
Yeah, not so much, Stephanie. We have that upper level low over there in the east, but also we have an upper level feature that's going to be impacting what may or may not happen in the Gulf of Mexico. You know, earlier I was talking about one of our forgotten storms the past 10 years. We talked yesterday about Rita, which was a huge hurricane that hit southwest Louisiana 10 years ago yesterday. Also this week, though, a system down in the Caribbean, in the Western Caribbean, that made landfall over the Yucatan Peninsula. Tropical Storm Matthew, 5 years ago. Most people don't remember it. A 60-mile-per-hour tropical storm, but it killed over 100 people in Mexico and Nicaragua, so it just doesn't take a big type storm, a big hurricane, to cause a lot of problems. And look at what we have right now. We have two systems on either side of our tropics here in the Pacific and in the Atlantic. This one down here, I need to make a quick mention of this, 80% chance of development over the next 5 days or so. This is going to be headed up toward Mexico, probably will make landfall as a tropical depression or a storm. So this will have some impacts come the early to middle part of next week. But this here, 1 in 5 chance of development with this in the Gulf of Mexico over the next, oh, probably 72 to 96 hours or so, next maybe 3 or 4 days. Not until it gets up here, though. Right now, it's interacting with land. It's a broad area of low pressure, a trough of low pressure, but it's got a lot of tropical juice with it, a lot of rainfall. That's going to be headed toward the Yucatan Peninsula on Sunday. A low pressure system will probably form, and it'll be somewhere in the Gulf of Mexico. Water temperatures this time of year still very warm enough to support a tropical type system. But as Stephanie was saying, the upper level winds and upper level features really going to be unfavorable for any type of significant development. But rainfall, heavy rainfall possible in the Gulf Coast Monday and Tuesday of next week. Alan, Steph, back to you.
Michael, thank you. Well, a Florida man says he is lucky to be alive after he got struck by lightning.
Yes, he shared his amazing ordeal with WPTV's Jason Hackett.
They say you have a better chance of being struck by lightning than winning the lottery. As far as Floyd Patterson is concerned, he did both.
I felt like I won the lottery because I have my life back.
The father of four was working at this construction site on a stormy day in Hope Sound last week. He was helping to load blocks onto the roof.
I reached up and I held on to the forks, and I was trying to steady the load for a perfect landing.
Suddenly, a bolt of lightning hit the top of the crane.
A big ball of fire like around me. It was all blue and white, all blue and white.
Unconscious on the floor, Patterson thought he had taken his final breath.
Everything that was done there on that deck was prepared for me to die.
It was there he says he had an out-of-body experience, a meeting with his maker, a plea to God not to take him just yet.
I got my kids. I got to see them grow up. I got to see them go to school. I at least got to see them graduate. I say, God, please, Please give me a second chance. I need a second chance to live.
That second chance was granted. Patterson regained consciousness and was rushed to the hospital. Apart from occasional headaches and some pain in his arm, he escaped relatively unharmed. Tattered clothes he was cut out of are all that's left of his near-death experience. With his faith stronger than ever, he's hugging his kids a little tighter. Thankful his life didn't end in a flash.
God spared my life to live to see another day, and I give him credit for that.
All right, that's from Jason Hackett.
And to not have any significant after effects.
Yeah,
I mean, some people,
amazing.
You know, really
other
struggle.
Than a couple of headaches. That's not bad. Well, still ahead on Wake Up Without, we got the first weekend of fall arriving, but it's not going to feel like it for a lot of folks.
No, we're talking record-breaking temperatures after your local on the 8th.
Let's head out to Denver and take a look at the Mile High City. Nice morning there. Right now, temperature 53 degrees. We got more coming up for you. After your local on the 8s on Wake Up With Al, right here on the Weather Channel.
I'm Jerry Bell II.
And Jerry Bell III.
I'm like a big bear, and he's my little cub. This little guy is nonstop. He's always one that hangs out with his friend. Gotta be prepared to sit at the edge of your seat and be ready to get up. There's no deep couch sitting. It's definitely not good for my back. This is the part I really don't like right here. What's that? It's a Swiffer wet jet. It almost feels like it's moving itself. It's kind of fun. That comes from my floor? Ugh. This is Deep Couch City.
Deep Couch City.
Centrum brings us the biggest news in multivitamin history. A moment when something so familiar becomes something so new. Introducing new Centrum Vitamins, a multivitamin that contains a full spectrum of essential nutrients you enjoy like a mint. New Centrum Vitamins, the coolest way yet to get your multivitamins.
AT&T and DirecTV are now one, which means you can watch movies while you're on the move, sitcoms while you sit on those, and even Fargo in Fargo. Binge while you lose weight and enjoy a good cliffhanger while you hang from a Why Am I Yelling? The revolution will not only be televised, the revolution will be mobilized. Introducing the all-in-one plan, only from DirecTV and AT&T.
Right on cue.
It's more than just a meal. It's Meow Mix Mealtime. With great taste and 100% complete nutrition, it's the only one cats ask for by name.
Hey, neighbor, LED bulbs can last for over 20 years and save hundreds of dollars on your energy bill. So stop by your neighborhood Ace now and get an LED dimmable indoor reflector bonus pack with two free bulbs.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
I don't want to live with the uncertainties of Hep C.
Or wonder whether I should seek treatment.
I am ready.
Because today, there's Harvoni, a revolutionary treatment for the most common type of chronic hepatitis C. Harvoni is proven to cure up to 99% of patients who've had no prior treatment. It's the one and only cure that's one pill once a day for 12 weeks. Certain patients can be cured with just 8 weeks of Harvoni. With Harvoni, there's no interferon, and there are no complex regimens. Tell your doctor if you have other liver or kidney problems or other medical conditions, and about all the medicines you take, including herbal supplements. Harvoni should not be taken with any medicines containing amiodarone, rifampin, or St. John's wort. It also should not be taken with any other medicine that contains Sovaldi. Side effects may include tiredness and headache.
I am ready to put Hep C behind me.
I am ready to be cured.
Are you ready? Ask your Hep C specialist if Harvoni is right for you.
What's up with this weather, huh?
Today's weather? Well, I'd get things done this morning because we've got some big changes rolling through this afternoon. Jim Cantore has that.
Sam, this is fascinating. Rapidly rising warm, moist air creating this huge cumulonimbus cloud. Oftentimes, the results can be electrifying. Back to you, Sam.
Great job, Jim. That should get you started on your day. So now, back to you.
Back to me.
Mm-hmm.
Sam Champion on the Weather Channel. Weather precise.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Tonight, cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Winds light and variable. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
On AMHQ.
I want to make sure everybody can get an idea of what's happening here.
Let's talk about that.
Let's lift the base of this.
You're about to see something you have never seen on television before.
29 minutes past the hour. Welcome back to Wake Up With Al.
It's finally Friday, and we have everything you need to get out the door, including fall arriving, but a little bit warmer train than average.
That's right, but is that going to have an effect on the economy? Our business weather expert, Paul Walsh, joins us with the Sweater Weather Index in just a few moments. But first, our top three, starting off with long-lasting coastal trouble. This upper-level low and then low off the coast, bringing heavy rain and wind, high surf, rip currents, and those rip currents can extend all the way up into Long Island. Look for also some fall warmth stretching from New England all the way back to the west. Temperatures anywhere from 5 to 20 degrees above average. And we're watching the Gulf for some sort of development. May not be named, but that won't stop it from causing a lot of wet weather and wind from New Orleans all the way to Tallahassee.
All right, let's talk about those coastal flooding concerns. In North Carolina is where we're going to start off. In Nag's Head yesterday, large waves came ashore. All stems from this low that Al was talking about here. And we're going to go face first into that low in just a second. But first, let's go face first into this video. There's the waves. And the erosion is significant. I retweeted a picture. Can't remember if it was Kitty Hawk or Kill Devil Hills, but it started with a K. Did you want to say something?
No.
Oh, okay.
I just went, uh-huh.
Oh, you went, uh-huh. Okay. So we are seeing significant erosion, and that's going to continue. And the reason why is we have this onshore push, and it's a little extra, a little harder of a push. You know, sometimes you try to give someone a little tap, and all of a sudden they go, like, falling over, and they go face first. Well, we have a low pressure to the south, a high pressure to the north, and with that, we're getting an onshore flow from both of those systems, so that's why it's a little bit rougher here around the Outer Banks. Showers and storms. Now, it's not only because of what's happening at the surface, but also into the upper levels the atmosphere. I always say the atmosphere is like a hamburger. I don't. So right now we're going to take you to the tomato layer. Our surface low is about here, and this is our upper level low. You can see it very clearly. So what is this doing? Well, it's bringing in the moisture. You can see that moisture stream coming up and around this low. It's also a cold pocket aloft. So we have cold air here around the tomato layer. What does cold air want to do? It wants to sink, right? Warm air wants to rise. We all pretty much know that. So the cold air is sinking down. That means it's going to be cold in Atlanta, 65 today for you. With the rain and the clouds on top of it, it's going to feel even colder than that. But we need rain. Just because things don't happen exactly how we want them to doesn't mean it's going to be bad in the end. This is good because look at this. It's happening right over the drought areas of North and South Carolina. So we need the rain, maybe not when we want it exactly, but such is life.
Some areas getting up more than 3 to 5 inches of rain. All right, well, high surf advisories in effect right now, parts of Virginia and coastal North Carolina.
Mike Seidel is live this morning in Va Beach, as they call it, or Virginia Beach. And Mikey, how has the erosion been up there? Because it has been pretty significant in the Outer Banks.
Well, I was out on the beach yesterday at sundown, and it's certainly not as significant as we've seen to our south to the Outer Banks. We don't have big cuts. Looks like we've lost some sand. But look at the wind this morning, still gusting upwards 20 to 25 miles an hour. The vegetation behind me, the flags a little higher up, picking up more of the wind coming off the Atlantic. This is a northeast wind. That's an eroding wind, and we're going to have 5 days of this through tomorrow and Sunday. So it's not so much how strong it's blowing, it's the fact it's so persistent day in and day out. Take you out to the beach yesterday, and it was a beautiful day in Virginia Beach. Temperatures in the upper 70s. We had the wind, had some folks frolicking on the edge of the surf. That's a good thing with those rip currents and that rip current threat continuing through the entire weekend. And the waves running about 5 feet or so. Offshore buoys this morning, 7 to 9 feet. Here's your forecast, hourly forecast. Dry this morning. All the rain has stayed to our south, down towards the North Carolina-Virginia border and the Outer Banks, and that's where they're going to have a higher rainfall totals this weekend. It will get wet here eventually later this afternoon, tonight, and your five-day forecast, a wet and breezy weekend. We could get some gusts to 30 miles an hour, but now keep in mind it's just the longevity of this wind blowing onshore, and one of the reasons, as Stephanie mentioned, is that high pressure in the northeast of New England, and that's why you've got some great weather for the weekend up your way.
Yeah, it is looking good. Mike, stay tuned and hang in there, my friend. We appreciate it. Hey, take a look right now. Oh, boy, what a mess. You got construction going on right now this hour in Times Square, so everybody's got to funnel into that one little area.
Oh, it's kind of like the winds. That is a great example of what's happening.
That's right.
With
there
the winds.
Except the traffic
the
is moving
coast.
Much slower than the wind.
That's true.
Unfortunately. So we're looking for a partly cloudy day, high about 76 degrees. On this day in 1981, Sandra Day O'Connor becoming the first female U.S. Supreme Court justice in history, sworn in by Chief Justice Warren Burger. Well, there has been a lot of warmth, and look at this average temperature so far for September. Portland, Maine, you're way above the record of 64.7. Boston, you're very close to it. New York, you're moving up above it. The only place really kind of cooler than average, Washington, D.C., at 76.1 degrees. Right now, D.C.'s at 64, 66 in Philly, 56 Buffalo, Burlington looking at a temperature of 47, Bangor, 42. Right now, we're looking for highs at Pittsburgh, 78. Tomorrow, we'll get up to 73 in New York City, just a little bit above average. 69 in Burlington, D.C., 70. And then on Sunday, the warmth still hangs in there, although not quite as warm as it has been. And as we look at New York's forecast going into the weekend, pretty nice. Temperatures will be into the low to mid-70s.
Well, it's time now for our news headlines. And Alex Witt is joining us from MSNBC. Good morning.
Good morning, you guys. This is a terrible story, unfortunately, that we start off with. As I say good morning to all of you, it was a chaotic scene along the way to the Muslim holy site of Mecca. Massive crowds and confusion caused a stampede that killed more than, get this, 700 people, injuring at least 800. This happened yesterday, just miles from Mecca's Grand Mosque. Despite security and infrastructure developments, this is the latest in a string of tragedies at the Hajj. It is a pilgrimage every Muslim is expected to take once in their lifetime. It's claimed 3,700 lives since 1990, and Saudi Arabia's leader, King Salman, has now ordered an investigation. Heading to Seattle, where yesterday a deadly collision between a charter bus and a popular tourist ride known as duck boats was deadly. Four people dead, 15 hospitalized, 12 of them in intensive care. And Pope Francis, of course, has taken the Big Apple by storm. Last night, thousands cheered as he waved from his Popemobile along Fifth Avenue, right outside our studios here. He was on his way to New York City's St. Patrick's Cathedral. Speaking at a packed Vespers evening prayer service, the pontiff gave thanks to the nuns and religious women of the U.S. And today, the Pope will address the U.N. General Assembly. Later this evening, he leads a mass to Madison Square Garden. There it is. All right, guys.
Thanks so much.
I was going to walk in and say hi.
We've got more coming up.
These wings are pretty great, huh?
Yeah.
What is that?
Oh, it's a wing ring.
What's a wing ring?
I ask it what kind of wings I should have, and it tells me. Today it said honey barbecue.
Well, I want to ask it a question.
Oh, you know what? I got like 2% battery on this thing.
Well, come on, let me just...
Yeah, I wish I could.
So. Your battery in a ring?
Yeah, it's like 8 gigs.
That's two different things. One is memory and one's battery
life. Cool. All I know is like, no, you can't use it.
Good luck choosing 100% all white meat boneless chicken wings in 6 delicious flavors. Or buy one, get one free every Monday night. This is how you Sonic.
Jedi. They're just wise old men who like to be comfortable. So they wear robes. Remember, tight-fitting clothing leads to chafing. Chafing leads to anger. And, well, anger is the path to the dark side.
The best place in the galaxy to get low prices on everything Star Wars. Walmart.
At the Friskies Playhouse, the cats and us are always busy thinking of new ways to make treat time fun. That's how we came up with new Friskies Pull and Play. With tender string treats, cats can eat. That part was their idea. Lucy always thought string should be edible. Chloe thought the same. And Charlie, well, he's up for anything, as long as it's fun. New Friskies Pull and Play with tender strings. The whole new way to treat and play.
Selling 18 homes? Easy. Building them all in 4.5 months? Now that was a leap. I was calling on every favor I could to track down enough lumber to get the job done. And I knew I could rely on American Express to help me buy those building materials. There are always going to be unknowns. You just have to be ready for them.
Another step on the journey. Will you be ready when growth presents itself? Realize your buying power at open.com.
When heartburn comes creeping up on you, fight back with relief so smooth and fast. Tums Smoothie starts dissolving the instant it touches your tongue and neutralizes stomach acid at the source. Smoothies, only from Tums.
There's no oxygen!
Everest is the movie event like nothing you have experienced.
The storm of the century is headed your way.
Get out there! I need help! Get up!
Based on the incredible true story.
I'm not leaving you behind. Come on!
Everest, now playing in theaters everywhere. Rated PG-13.
Let's tap into new floors in a new way. Step up the savings and get moving. Yeah, like that. Let's do this. Get Pergo Haley Oak Laminate for just $2.29 a square foot. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground. Weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Tonight, cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Winds light and variable. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
It's past the hour. Good morning, Chicago. Temperatures into the mid-60s. You'll probably get up to about 75 degrees today.
If you're looking to explore the great outdoors, head to the Hyde Park Jazz Festival. It's taking place more than 10 venues throughout the park over 2 days with performances by Lawrence Hobgood and trumpeter Ferez Whitted, among others.
Very cool. Well, in today's forecast factor, want to wrap up the week with the economic outlook for fall.
So maybe you're planning on hitting the stores this weekend for a look at what's hot retail-wise. We are joined by business weather expert Paul Walsh. Paul, thanks for coming in.
Good morning.
So the calendar says fall, but I'm sure the stores already have like winter gear in them because everything always seems to be like seasons ahead of time.
That's right.
Are people buying the stuff or is it just too hot?
No, people buy when they need products. It's especially true nowadays because there's always something there when you need it. So therefore, the weather becomes a huge component in terms of making sales work. So when it's warmer than normal in September, people are still thinking summer. They're not buying fall.
So explain the sweater weather index you've developed.
Well, we did a survey on weather.com. We talked to about 7,000 or so of our closest friends all around the country, and we said, what temperature do you start wearing a sweater? Mm-hmm. And interestingly, as you would expect, the farther north you go, the colder it needs to get before people start thinking about wearing sweaters. So in South Dakota and areas like that, it really needs to get in almost into the low 50s before it's sweater weather.
I'm surprised 60 is considered sweater weather in the South. I would think it would be closer to 70.
Well, less than 60. So if it's 60 or below, then it becomes sweater weather. Huh. Florida, 65, Arizona at 65. So there's about a 10 or 15 degree gradient between south to north. So the impact of the weather and how it drives our behavior is all a function of where you live. It's like politics.
And then the economy, right. And then the economy to follow that. I mean, listen, it's just a few weeks of like a tad warmer. Can that really shake the economy that much?
Not the economy, but it does impact retailers because what happens is in September, they've got all those products that they're trying to sell. If it's warmer than normal and people aren't buying them, then they're actually forced to take markdown. So they actually lose money, but it's great for consumers because when we get to October, I guarantee you it's going to get cold.
So what's on sale now?
I think by the time we get in the end of September, fleece, sweaters, even light jackets are all going to be marked down significantly. And when we get into October, it's going to feel like fall. I guarantee it. No doubt it's going to get cold.
Right.
All right. So let's talk about the Pope and climate change and China. A lot of products are made in China, right? And yep. China just announced a cap and trade plan this morning. And how is this going to affect our economy?
Well, I think overall the effect that global warming or climate change is having on our businesses. I was yesterday in a conference all day with a risky business organization, which was founded by Mayor Bloomberg and Hank Paulson, and it was business leaders really talking about how they are going to be adapting and the opportunities actually they see in terms of leveraging technology and creating technologies that will help us adapt to climate change. So the adoption of the technologies that are going to be helping us deal with it are actually driving the economy from a new business perspective.
And new job perspective?
Exactly. There'll be a whole new economy sprouting up out of these new technologies that are being developed to help deal with this problem.
And I mean, at least China's doing, everyone's complaining China's doing nothing, at least now there is a cap and trade in place.
Exactly. Yeah, it's a global problem, and global countries are stepping up.
Finally.
All right, Paul Walsh, thanks so much. And for more from the latest business weather news, check out forecastfactor.com on weather.com. Forecastfactor.weather.com.
Now it's time for a dust devil. And this one was a little bit bigger than your average, just kind of quick little spin of two forecasters at the National Weather Service in Louisiana captured this video yesterday.
You can see this thing grow in size, happened just outside Floyd, Louisiana, and then in a matter of minutes, it dissipated. So kind of interesting, to watch this thing. These guys were actually from the Jackson, Mississippi forecast office, and they were doing a little travel.
So how these form is just a temperature difference kind of close to the surface. It's kind of like hot and hotter type of a thing, opposed to a tornado, which is from a big supercell thunderstorm or just a thunderstorm. So they just form a little bit different, and all of that dirt you see is just what is picking up from the ground.
It's just fascinating to look at, really.
I was listening to it also.
I know. Yeah, all right. Well, from beach erosion and storms off the mid-Atlantic coast to an area of development in the Gulf, we are tracking tropical activity close to home. And as you like to say, it doesn't have to be a named storm to cause big problems.
It could just be a question mark.
That's right.
You'll get what we're talking about a little bit later, a little inside joke there. And we're counting down to college football Saturday. And with it, a threat of storms from Gainesville to Columbia, Auburn, the SEC. Even in towards the Big Ten, we have a look at your forecast after your local on the 8s.
The Great Outdoors, brought to you by Mercedes-Benz, certified pre-owned, certified affordable luxury.
We don't just certify our pre-owned vehicles. We inspect, analyze, and recondition each one until it's nothing short of a genuine certified pre-owned Mercedes-Benz for the next new owner. Hurry into your authorized Mercedes-Benz dealer during our certified pre-owned sales event now through September 30th for exceptional offers.
I asked my dentist if an electric toothbrush was going to clean better than a manual. He said sure, but don't get just anyone. Get one inspired by dentists with a round brush head.
Go pro with Oral-B. Oral-B's rounded brush head cups your teeth to break up plaque and rotates to sweep it away. And Oral-B delivers a clinically proven superior clean versus Sonicare Diamond Clean.
My mouth feels super clean.
Oral-B. Know you're getting a superior clean.
I'm never going back to a manual brush.
Lowe's presents How to Be a Good Listener.
This new pedestal sink just screams elegance.
It also whispers, Dan, you're a genius because you got this guy to install it for you.
Get your home guest ready with Select Euro Vanities, now only $99 at Lowe's.
When is your flu shot more than a flu shot? When it helps give a life-saving vaccine to a child in need in a developing country. Thanks to customers like you, Walgreens Get a Shot, Give a Shot program has helped provide 7 million vaccines. Make your flu shot make a world of difference. Walgreens, at the corner of happy and healthy.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6.
I could tell you more about boilers than I can about computers. Processing credit cards with Square has made collecting money very easy. the funds are deposited right away. I know and I can rely on having that money to be able to use for the success of the business. It's just a very simple process.
Accept all major credit cards with Square and get your money fast. Get your free card reader at square.com.
Hey, who brought the big present?
Happy birthday.
Oh, thanks, honey.
I downloaded the CNBC app so you can watch Squawk Box wherever you are.
This is the best gift I ever got.
Ever?
Oh, best gift ever. Best gift ever. Best gift ever. I actually mean it this time.
This is the existential question, is whether people bring it back and at what rate.
May I be excused? Yeah. Yeah. Happy birthday, Dad.
Betty, I'm trying to watch.
No.
This kind of weather, all bets are off.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Tonight, cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Winds light and variable. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Just about 50 past the hour. Welcome back to Wake Up With Al. On Monday, winterizing your attic. We're going to talk to the EPA about what you can do now to help you keep your energy bills down before that cold weather rolls in. But right now, heading back to Atlanta, Michael Lowry watching the chances of storms developing in the Gulf. Michael.
Hey, good morning, Al, and good morning to everybody at home. That's right. Going into the weekend, if you live along the Gulf Coast, really anywhere from Texas to the west coast of Florida, something to watch for some possible development here over the next several days. We have two systems on either side of Central America that we have our eyes on. Invest 92E over here in the Pacific Ocean to the western side of Mexico, and then on the Atlantic side over here in the western Caribbean, we're watching for some development with that system. A much higher odds of development with this one here in the Pacific Ocean. I have to mention this because it's headed toward land, and it could bring some really heavy rainfall to parts of Mexico there, and the dangerous mudslides and landslides, something we're going to want to watch going into Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday of next week. We'll focus our attention here in the Gulf of Mexico because this system is going to be lifting over the Yucatan Peninsula into the Southern Gulf on Monday, and it's at that point we think there is some chance, about a 1 in 5 odds, the Hurricane Center is saying, of some sort of tropical, maybe even subtropical development. I'll explain what that means and why we think that is. Right now, it's just a broad area of low pressure, what we call a trough in the atmosphere, so winds are kind of turning like this around that dashed line that I just drew. This system is going to be moving, it's slowly moving toward the Gulf of Mexico this weekend, so on Sunday, we'll probably have some more defined area of low pressure approaching the Gulf of Mexico, and then by Monday, it's going to be zipping pretty quickly to the north. And look at all of this juice, all of this tropical moisture that is going to be pulling northward with it. So that's what I want you to take away from this. Regardless of whether or not anything develops, it's going to be bringing a lot of rainfall and a lot of moisture to the northern Gulf Coast the early part of next week. At the upper part of the atmosphere, even though we'll have this sort of weak area of low pressure sitting over here, water temperature is warm enough to support a tropical system, but the upper part of the atmosphere, the winds are going to be screaming out of the southwest, and this sort of wind pattern at the upper part of the atmosphere does not favor tropical development. So if we get anything out of this, it's going to get a lot of its energy probably from the upper part of the atmosphere, and that won't allow this to become a strong tropical storm or a hurricane. But imagine this big comma-shaped cloud pattern across the Gulf Coast for the early part of the week. So 3-plus inches of rainfall possible from anywhere from South Louisiana over into the Florida Panhandle through Wednesday. Something to keep an eye to. If it gets a little stronger, we could be dealing with coastal impacts too, you know, in terms of maybe some minor coastal flooding, but that's still left to be seen. Elsewhere in the tropics, we have this tropical depression Ida. That's kind of just being meandering out there. It's not going to make it across the Atlantic Ocean. Let's talk really quickly about Depression 6C in the Central Pacific Ocean. My gosh, we've had, this is now the seventh, or the sixth rather, tropical system that we've had in the Central Pacific Ocean. Steph, our record before this was 4, but thankfully this one, it will be moving to the south of Hawaii. No impacts expected there, other than maybe some increased surf come the weekend. Back to you.
Yeah, which is a good thing for, yeah. For Chicago. Sorry, Chicago's next. Good thing for the surfers in Hawaii. Yeah. Boy, it is Friday. All right, wheels on the bus go round and round, and we've got your bus stop forecast coming up this morning. Plus, it's college football Saturday. Oh, be still, my heart. It's after your local on the 8s, or really 2 minutes.
Thanks for calling Angie's List. How may I help you?
I heard I could call Angie's List if I needed work done around my house at a fair price.
You heard right. Just tell us what you need done, and we'll find a top-rated provider to take care of it.
So I could get a faulty light switch fixed?
Yep.
Or have a guy refinish my floors?
Absolutely.
Or send someone out to groom my Pookie?
Yeah. Pookie is what you call your...
My dog.
Yes, we can do that.
Real help from real people. Come see what the new Angie's List can do for you.
And when you bundle your home and auto insurance through Progressive, you'll save a bundle.
Jamie.
Right.
Make a bad bundle joke, a buck goes in the jar.
I guess that's just how the cookie bundles. Now you're gonna have two bundles of joy.
I'm not pregnant.
I'm gonna go.
There you go.
Bundle bee coming. It was worth it.
Saving you a bundle when you bundle. Now that's Progressive.
You tuck here, you tuck there. If you're a toe tucker because of toenail fungus, ask your doctor now about prescription keratin. Use daily, keratin drops may kill the fungus at the site of infection and get to the root of your toe tucking. Keratin may cause irritation at the treated site. Most common side effects include skin peeling, ingrown toenail, redness, itching, and swelling. Tell your doctor if you have any side effect that bothers you or does not go away. Stop toe tucking and get the drop on toenail fungus. Ask your doctor today about keratin.
Away. Is the smell of salt in the air. It's the sound a seashell makes. Away is a place that's beyond your imagination, yet well within your means. Find your away. For a dealer in the RV that's right for you, visit GoRVing.com.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Good morning, Chicago. Look at Wrigley Field. Cloudy conditions, temperatures in the 60s, and we want to show you the bus stop forecast. Even though there's nothing like that sign at Wrigley Field, you got to go see the Ivies. Even though my Cubbies struggle, it's still, there's just such history. 73 cloudy skies there. The Cubs can clinch their first playoff berth since 2008 today when they host the Pirates at Wrigley. Also, their first 90-win season in 7 years. So, go Cubbies. I'll take that, right? Let's have a look at Nashville, and we will see cooler temperatures with potentially a few showers. Then into Washington, D.C. How are things shaping up for us? Well, we are going to feel some of the effects of that upper-level low with the cloud cover and 74. And then Raleigh, of course, this is where we're going to get the rain, all thanks to the system here into the southeast. Cold, too, thanks to the upper-level low. Well, new colorful pictures of Pluto this morning. The high-resolution images show a wide array of colors and varying terrain on the dwarf planet. A mountain range on Pluto's surface appears gray and blue. Its jagged ridgeline created what scientists have described as a snake skin-like appearance. Now, another image shows colors ranging from brown to white to shades in between. The images were captured by the New Horizons spacecraft on July 14th. This blows my mind that we can build something, send it all the way to Pluto, and take images this clear. They can send them back. Does that blow anyone else's mind? I mean, can we appreciate that instead of just saying, oh yeah, there's Pluto? Like, absorb that and appreciate and think about that for a second. Okay, now you can absorb and appreciate college football. Two different things, kind of on different ends of the spectrum here. We're talking Mississippi State at Auburn. Great weather for this game here, and it's going to be really comfortable as well. Then UCF at South Carolina, the Gamecocks there, that they had a rough game last weekend. We are going to see the cloud cover for us. And then a big matchup here, big rivalry, Tennessee versus Florida. Tennessee knocked out of the top 25. I still don't know why they were put in the top 25 to begin with, but regardless, this I feel like this is a they're kind of evenly matched, so it will be interesting to see what happens. Scattered showers and thunderstorms here in the swamp, and it'll be nice and humid as well. All right, everyone, good luck to all your teams out there. Al, let's wrap it up.
Steph, thank you, and thank you for waking up with us this morning. Coming up next, Sam Champion, Jem Delgado, Jim Cantore helping you plan the rest of your day. We hope to see you on Monday morning. Everybody have a great day.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, scattered thunderstorms, high 87, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour, chance of rain 40%. Tonight, cloudy skies, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible, low 74. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 87, chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Friday morning. Yep, first thing, we made it. That's amazing. September 25th, a lot going on as we get you ready for your weekend. Let's start with the amazing difference in the weather patterns all the way down the eastern seaboard. Frost and freeze advisories, watches, warnings in Maine. Coastal flooding going on in Chesapeake right now. And this tornado report. Families on St. John's Island, South Carolina, cut off. Crews have been working through the night. National Weather Service is on it first thing, first light this morning, surveying the damage. We'll talk about more. Hey, coastal low, it's not a tropical system, but the damage and what's going on underneath it with the flooding rain, the beach erosion, the steady winds, sure looks a little like one. We'll talk about the heavy rain and what you're going to get as you go in through the weekend. And this is going to be a big problem with a lot of weekend forecasts. Rip current risk, even if you don't have this coastal low up and down the eastern seaboard, good morning. Ocean City, New Jersey, beachgoers all the way into New York and all the way out toward the island. You're going to want to go because the temperatures are going to be warmer than normal, but get ready for the problem in the water. Jim Cantore this morning in Breckenridge, Colorado. Jim, I noticed a little hat, a little jacket. Yeah. The numbers are going to be warm later today, but they're not right now.
Well, we are at 9,600 feet, Sam Champion. So good morning from Breckenridge. Beautiful fall color. I mean, look at this. Fantastic. We're 38 right now, so we'll take it. Absolutely beautiful weather up here. The fall color is peaking. I mean, we are going to show you a fantastic show from Breckenridge, so just hang around for that. But let's talk about the East Coast here, because we are not out of the woods with this, okay? The low is going to come north out of Georgia. At the same time, the high builds into New England. There's actually even another piece of that high that's going to build in. So believe it or not, as bad as it is already, it's going to get worse tomorrow. The winds are going to pick up again in the Outer Banks, again in the Tidewater, again along the Jersey Shore. So that means rip current risk is going to be high. We are going to see coastal flooding as well. And the element that we're going to add in this situation is also some very, very heavy rain, Sam. So keep an eye on the Tidewater area of Virginia, especially at the time of high tide. If it's pouring rain and that tide's in, we got some trouble. We'll talk more about that in just a moment.
Back to you. Getting everybody ready for their weekend is a very changing forecast. Jim Cantore will talk more about that eastern system. And, of course, we've got a lot of other things to do. But let's dive into some of these pictures on the southeast and along the east coast this morning. The southeast coast could bring in as much rain as any tropical system. And it stretches all the way from the Atlantic Ocean well into Alabama. The swirl on this thing is just unbelievable. And so's the heavy rain. This morning in Atlanta, be careful of ponding water on the roads. Greenville, Cape Hatteras, Paris, similar situation. Heavy rain and flooding chances increase as you start to move even closer to the coastline as more rain will develop today. Conditions on the coast will also be problematic. Not just the rip currents we've already talked about, but the rough surf. We've seen it as high as 9 feet in the last 24 hours when this all started. We're still looking at that 9 to 10 foot range. Hey, Mike Seidel is live in Virginia Beach this morning. Mike, rough surf, gusty winds still around for these people.
Yeah, so this is going to be a problem all weekend long. But first, let's head down to Charleston and get back to that possible tornado touchdown around 1 a.m. this morning in the Johns Island area. West Ashby getting some damaged trees knocked down, some siding ripped off homes. National Weather Service crew will be out there in the next couple of hours to confirm whether it was an EF0 or an EF1, likely not any higher than that. Meanwhile, back here at Virginia Beach, look at the surf this morning pounding these beaches, and it's not so much the wind, it's the persistent wind over 4 to 5 days through the weekend. These are northeast winds, that's an eroding wind. Right now, not very strong, but it is gonna pick up tomorrow, tonight and tomorrow, as we get the squeeze play from the high to the north and the low coming up the coast. These are about 4 to 5 footers. Here comes the surf. Here's where high tide was about an hour ago. You can see the debris line here as they come down the beach and empty the trash cans. That was the debris line. This is a wide, wide beach here, Virginia Beach. Now, I've seen it underwater with Isabel in 03, nor Ida. Remember that one, November of 09, the whole beach was underwater. That is not going to happen today. We'll keep an eye on it tomorrow because by late tomorrow and Sunday morning, tides will be running as high as 1 to 2 feet above average. And so far, Sam, we don't have deep cuts in the beach for erosion. We do have some undulations. As far as the rain goes, right now it's all to our south, primarily down in the Outer Banks, eastern North Carolina, into the North Carolina-Virginia border. We've had a few drops here. But again, the five-day forecast. Winds will pick up tomorrow. We could gust over 30 miles an hour, and rain, too, moving in here, although the highest rainfall total, Sam, will be down in the eastern parts of North Carolina. Breezy day out here, but it will get windier tonight and tomorrow. Sam, back to you.
Oh, yeah, Mike, a lot of the effects will start to lift into your area. You'll get into it later today and certainly for the weekend. Those deep cuts of erosion you were talking about missing on the Virginia Beach are definitely all along the Carolina coast. A lot of people sending us those Twitter pictures. Let's talk about this rain. If you're talking about 5 to 8 inches of rain, who's getting it? And is it all weekend long? Tracking that coastal low off the east is an important thing, and Jim Cantore is doing it for us this morning. Morning, Jim.
Hey, good morning, Sam. We talked about this all week, and certainly a big concern of the tide water as we're going to see the worst of the impacts on Saturday. We'll still have them moving up the Jersey Shore on Sunday. So let's get into this a little bit. Certainly some very heavy rain this morning. As we know, 12:52 in the morning, I see a tornado warning show up on my Twitter feed. Unbelievable there down around Charleston. The National Weather Service is going to go out and survey that today. But that's all a part of this upper-level low and surface-low combination here. So if we had this a little bit larger, you can see the very deep tropical connection that's coming up from this. So that means some pretty heavy rain. You can see that blue color and that green color just east of Wilmington. That's some pretty heavy rain. All right, and that's what's coming up. And there it is right there, coming up toward the Wilmington area this morning. So let's take a look at this, guys. We got a lot of problems along the coastal areas, Wilmington, down toward Myrtle Beach, back toward North Georgia. It's been a wet couple of days in Atlanta. This is moving into Birmingham. Everybody getting rain here in this picture needs it. It's been very, very dry. Greenville, as a matter of fact, is one of those areas. Let's take it to Greenville, South Carolina. I was just there over the past weekend for the beautiful Euphoria Festival, and they had a great time there, but it was dry. A lot of the creeks, a lot of the streams, incredibly dry there in Greenville, South Carolina. They are wet this morning, though, and certainly adding to water. So this has been nothing but good news. The RPM showing the heaviest rain, pretty much staying in the Outer Banks today. All right, we'll see once we get that wad of rain near Wilmington and Morehead City what happens to it. But look at what happens on Saturday, especially where Mike is. Look at all of southeastern Virginia, just soaked here. This is where we're talking about 3 to 5 inches of rain coming into the picture, and that stays with us all day Saturday. The problem is that's going to be combined with the worst pressure gradient and the highest winds. So at the time of high tide, Sam, you can see the water totals we're expecting there. We are going to have strongest onshore wind. We're going to have rain coming down out of the sky, and unfortunately, probably some high water in some areas around the tidewater. So that's the biggest concern for Virginia going forward. Back in Breck in just a moment. Let's go back to Sam right now.
All right, Jim, and you're exactly right. The focus of the models looks like it's a straight shot for that rain and wind right into from Virginia Beach into Norfolk. Jen, let's get people ready in the Northeast for their weekend. Big difference in temperatures from, like, say, Boston to New York. 10 degrees difference.
Absolutely. Now. And we look at the Southeast. We know they're under the effects of the area low pressure. To the north, you're being hugged by the high, and the high bringing you spectacular weather. As we look ahead for New York right now, dry conditions. You're going to see sunshine out there, and the temperatures, well, you're racing to the warmest September on record. As we're going to take you out for the day, notice a few more clouds around, but your temperatures will be in the 70s, above average where we should be for this time of the year. As we move that ahead and we look across parts of the Northeast, the setup, there's the ridge of high pressure, but all this warmth just riding that ridge, and for areas including parts of the Northeast, 10 to 15 degrees, but if you want warmer air, go out to the plains. We're looking at numbers almost 25 degrees above average. Today, the winds are going to be coming in from the east northeast. 5 degrees above average for you in Boston with a high of 65, 75 in New York. And then we look ahead through tomorrow, still under the effects of the easterly wind. However, wind coming in off the water, dropping you down to 64 Boston, 70 in D.C. And I know the Pope is heading to Philadelphia tomorrow. And speaking of which, we want to show you the forecast for the big mass that's set up on Sunday. It looks like we're going to see some rain around coming in as we head later into the afternoon. But overall, weather looks great for the Pope. Well, we have a system that we're watching in the Gulf and the coastal low bringing that rain along the Carolinas. What will this mean for your weekend and this town in the Outer Banks?
Currently in our area, 75.
It's after the hour, getting you ready for your weekend. And if it is the Southeast that you will spend your weekend, we got to talk. A washout this weekend along parts of the North Carolina coast, really all of it. Rain and more than rain, possible thunderstorms, even looking at Wrightsville Beach right now, 73 degrees is what we're looking at. These conditions continue. The rough surf, we will have some beach erosion. This is going to go on. And then the rain really starts focusing a little bit further up the coastline as we get into the weekend. So, let's talk about what's going on there right now. This was a scene in Kitty Hawk, North Carolina on Tuesday when we saw waves 9 to 10 feet high. And it was just taking and clearing away that coastline. This is what Mike Seidel was talking about in his live shot this morning. Those deep cuts of erosion all along the beach. We've seen more pictures just like that this morning. Joining us now is Sam Walker of the Outer Banks Voice with an update on the situation. Hey, good morning, Sam. When last we saw you, you were out there with everything buffeting around you. We were just getting started with this wind. So how's the coastline now?
Well, the coastline is holding up pretty well considering the conditions. We haven't really seen any beach overwash. We've seen more erosion, especially north on the north beaches, such as in Kitty Hawk, that area where we had the washout in May. We've seen more of those sandbags are protecting Highway 12, and that small area of the beach road have been exposed. But nowhere else have we really seen any overwash yet. It looks like tomorrow may be when the things are worse. But what we have gotten is finally the rain has arrived and has arrived in buckets.
Now, I'm looking right now at the sandbagging. I guess this is video that you sent to us. That cut in the erosion looks to be pretty tall, Sam. Is that like more than 7 feet high, the shots that we're looking at?
Yeah, it's about 15 feet from where the beach is right now on the surface of the water to the top of the road. We lost a 300-foot section of dune back in May with a nor'easter.
Sure, yep.
crews came in August and were able to put in a permanent fix with sandbags along the roadbed. And those sandbags, as we said, they've been exposed by this latest nor'easter, and it looks like they might get even more exposure as we get another high tide this afternoon. But again, tomorrow is when we're going to really see if things get rough.
Yeah, and hoping things will relax a little bit by the time we get into the second half of the weekend. Sam Walker, stay with us. Let us see everything that's going on in your area. We appreciate your time this morning. Sam, always good to get those images live and straight from you. This may be the first weekend of fall, but some folks are still having that summer feeling, Jen.
Yeah, they're looking at temperatures in some of these locations 10 to 15 degrees above average. How about you, Chicago? You are enjoying the warmth this morning. We're starting it off early. Look at the roadways moving nice and smooth, but they're dry. I want to point that out to you today. Highs right near the mid-70s. As we take you over and we look at the graphics for today and we show you the water vapor, we're going to kind of geek out for you. We have two areas that we're watching. Here's our low in the Midwest, and then, of course, we have our one that's across parts of the Southeast. Well, if you noticed yesterday, the same low just started to retrograde. It went backwards, and here's why. Big Brother low right here was actually pushing it over towards the west. So eventually, you're going to start to see things drying out for areas like Omaha, and you desperately need it. But the heat, if you notice, the jet stream's all the way up towards the north, so this is allowing those temperatures to soar. Omaha, as well as into Sioux Falls, you're still looking at some showers. This is our low, but the good news is by 9 o'clock, we are going to start to see things clearing out. The rain comes to an end. You need to dry up after days of heavy rainfall, and then we're going to start to see the sun popping out, just like for Chicago, as well as into Green Bay. Not going to be a bad day in the Midwest. As we look ahead for areas, including parts of the upper Midwest, this ridge keeping you nice and warm. But areas, including parts of the plains, look at this. This is 25 degrees above average. And we're going to see those temperatures, even for Omaha, warming up once we get the rain and the clouds out of here. For today, high of 83 degrees in Kansas City, North Platte. You're just a little cool because you have rain. And then we look at Minneapolis, 76 for you. So really nice weather. St. Louis, maybe you're going there today. High of 86. The average high should be 75. And we're going to keep the 80s all the way around through next week. This is the end of September, and many places are racing ahead for the warmest September on record. Unbelievable.
Yeah, it really is. Both of us the same thing at the same time, because you're looking at 85 and 86 Monday and Tuesday, well into fall. All right, we've got your forecast going from the Midwest to Northeast all the way into the Southeast. This is where we turn the weather back over to you and Anna Rittis with all of your pictures.
That's right. You are our eyes out there, Sam. We're watching your morning commute in the Southeast. Atlanta, the downtown connector, absolutely littered with crashes because of this morning rain. Wilmington, North Carolina, you're also seeing a slow and sluggish commute this morning. Thankfully, no airport delays at this moment. Let's head to Columbia, South Carolina. An incredible capture of someone being rescued from a car that's been stalled out from all of the rain that you saw yesterday. 2.84 inches yesterday in a number of places across Columbia, South Carolina. We head to Florida, Cape Coral. You also saw some flooding yesterday. We had reports of water spouts. Look at this car also trying to make it through a flooded street. And our last picture coming out of Texas, a funnel cloud was captured out in Vernon. We had reports of thunderstorm wind damage, anywhere from 55 mile an hour gusts to even some trees down, Sam. Keep sending us those pictures. Use the hashtag MyWeather, but be very careful out on the roads if you're especially in Atlanta or Wilmington, North Carolina. We're seeing a lot of crashes this morning.
All right. We'll continue to follow the story of the big area of low pressure pushing into the Southeast. And of course, we're showing you the erosion, the coastal problems, but there have been more problems than that. Look at the possible tornado. And we're going to be updating you on this situation when we come back. This is in Johns Island. This is just outside of Charleston, South Carolina. Coming up as we get crews in, the daylight in this morning, and the National Weather Service in Charleston in, we'll talk about the issues there. Look at the line of storms. This is that radar recap, and certainly some trouble in that zone.
I love you.
Love you too.
One minute. Hi. We need to do this. Yes.
Letting go.
I'll say a word.
It's a little easier when you've saved for college with State Farm.
Chrysler continues to break new ground in fuel efficiency, quality, and innovation, which is impressive. But doing it for 90 years is a reason to celebrate. And there's even more to celebrate with 0% APR for 72 months at the Chrysler Anniversary Celebration event. Now get 0% APR financing for 72 months on all 2015 Chrysler vehicles.
I've been a poor man and I've been a king. I've had my life and the world on a string. I've traveled many roads, but I'm so far from done. Good to know there's so much to live for.
This kind of weather, all bets are off.
I get compliments on my beautiful home all the time, but I just wish all of my friends knew how much work went into making this place as lovely as it is.
Well, that's an interesting idea.
Some people think you can make a home beautiful without lifting a finger.
With JossAndMaine.com, decorating is simple. Sign up for free and shop a hand-picked selection of furniture and decor up to 70% off. Sign up at JossAndMaine.com today.
People who have been diagnosed with mesothelioma have many questions. How did I get this disease? What are my treatment options? How will this affect my loved ones? You need answers, which is why we offer a free book written by medical professionals who have treated mesothelioma. Call toll-free at 1-800-200-6120 or go to mesoonly.com. There's no obligation, so call toll-free at 1-800-200-6120.
What's up with this weather, huh?
Today's weather? Well, I'd get things done this morning because we've got some big changes rolling through this afternoon. Jen Delgado, let's show her where these storms are coming from.
We'll be seeing some heavy rains this afternoon, possibly causing some flooding downtown. So the kids' soccer practice? Well, likely it's going to be a wet one, Sam.
That should get you started on your day. So now back to you.
Back to me.
Mm-hmm.
Sam Champion on the Weather Channel. Weather precise.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, scattered thunderstorms. High 87. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Chance of rain, 40%. Tonight, cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 87. Chance of rain, 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Minutes after the hour, we're going to show the radar recap of this storm that kind of moved across the Charleston, Carolina coastline. This is the one that kind of triggered off that reported tornado. Several homes damaged after that tornado moved across Johns Island overnight. Now, officials say about 10 homes got the worst of the damage here. Numerous trees out, power lines down on the roads. And immediately, as soon as the storm passed, people got right out, helping each other clear the way around the area. You're looking at some of the images of folks clearing that debris right after the storm. So let's get into the area right now. Charleston County Department, Fire Chief Department, Chief James Gee is with us this morning. Hey, good morning, Chief. How are you?
I'm doing very good. How are you?
I'm well, thank you. Can you give us just an update on the situation? The images that we have were from overnight, so now that we're getting to the morning hours, how are things now?
Well, things have gotten much better, especially with getting some of the debris removed. We have Berkeley County Electric that's moving very safely and methodically through the area to make sure the power lines are out of the way and safe. And then we have the South Carolina Department of Transportation doing the heavy lifting as it relates to the trees and other debris. We still have emergency crews out there assessing the damage in the rest of the area, and that we have the American Red Cross out here helping people that have been displaced. Excuse me.
Yeah, absolutely. And now what we know of, there have been no injuries. Do you have any update on that?
Yeah, we're very happy to report that there were no civilian injuries and no firefighter injuries.
All right, fantastic. Good news. And there are places to avoid in the area today. What are they?
Well, yes, we have Main Road and Route 17, which is Savannah Highway. Those traffic lights are being controlled by the Charleston County Sheriff's Office. Also at Main Bank Highway and Main Road, the traffic lights are blinking red and yellow, so people need to use caution going through that area. We still have portions of River Road shut down. An old pond road shut down as they cleared debris. And then Thickling Hill Road, which Patton Road turns into Thickling Hill, still clearing debris from that area. So we're asking that everybody please avoid those areas if possible.
All right. Charleston County Fire Department Battalion Chief James Gee with us this morning, just updating us on what happened last night and the conditions there this morning. Appreciate it. There is more bad weather in the Charleston area today. It looks like it'll continue that way as we head into the weekend. Hey, Jim, when we were talking during the break, we were looking at that radar signature, and yeah, it definitely looks like they had a little spin up there, right?
Yeah, well, you saw all the trees. So, you know, what the correlation coefficient is, or the tornado debris signature, is showing us that we don't have raindrops. We have something very, very different. So it causes that to drop out, and you can see a very clear signature of that. And when we couple that with the TVS, which is the vorticity that you see on the storm relative velocity, you got a home run. You know that's a tornado at night, and that's why the Weather Service was so confident in issuing a tornado warning there. So they're going to go out there today at Johns Island and West Ashley and certainly get an idea of what came through here. As you mentioned, 10 homes suffering damage. We don't know to what extent. But here you see the radar, and there's a clear couplet with the green and the blue right there, west to southwest of Charleston, of basically wind that is going in inverse directions very, very close together. So what you do with that is you take it and you say, all right, let's marry that with the correlation coefficient to see if I actually have debris, because we know thunderstorms produce rain, they produce hail, but in this case, notice the debris signature showing up, the dropout. And even going further on in time, this becomes much more clear as it gets up toward Johns Island. So if we advance that, you can clearly see that debris signature, and that really lines up very, very well with the TVS. So very high confidence in issuing a tornado warning and actually calling it a confirmed tornado during the warning. Because of what we see right there on the radar, that's the advantage of the dual pole. All right, guys, let's get back into what we got going on the East Coast, because, again, we are not out of the woods yet, especially for the Tidewater area, Southeast Virginia. Look at that rain coming in to Myrtle Beach this morning, into Wilmington, North Carolina, Carolina Beach. The Outer Banks still getting crushed. We still have the onshore flow. There's much more where that came from. Look at this. Low pressure to the south, just about to the west of Charleston, actually, and high pressure, which is still building down into New England today. So the gradient gets worse. And look at that fetch, by the way. It is huge. It is absolutely huge. And that gradient is going to move up the Maryland coast, the Delaware coast. It's going to move up the Jersey Shore as well. And we are going to have that 800-mile fetch, which, by the way, is about the distance from New York City to Atlanta, just pushing water and pushing water all the way into that coastline. My biggest concern, Sam, is if we line up the high tide cycles in southeastern Virginia, at the same time the heavy rain is coming down, that water's not going to be able to get out, and we will have some flooding tomorrow. Watch out Saturday.
AT&T and DirecTV are now one, which means you can watch movies while you're on the move, sitcoms while you sit on those, and even Fargo in Fargo. Binge while you lose weight and enjoy a good cliffhanger while you hang from a Why Am I Yelling? The revolution will not only be televised, the revolution will be mobilized. Introducing the all-in-one plan, only from DirecTV and AT&T.
Hurry in, buy one, take one is back. Tonight, enjoy breadsticks, salad, and your choice of entrees, like smoked mozzarella chicken. Then take home another entree for tomorrow free. It's two delicious nights of togetherness. Buy one, take one, starting at $12.99 at Olive Garden.
Are you sending your kids to school with an allergy medicine that may make them drowsy? Only Children's Claritin provides non-drowsy 24-hour allergy relief.
And it's the number one pediatrician-recommended non-drowsy brand.
In class and out, your kids can live Claritin clear.
When your windshield needs fixed, trust Safelite. For these parents, driving around was the only way to get their baby to sleep. So when their windshield got cracked,
we can't drive this car.
They wanted it fixed right. So they scheduled with SafeLite. Our exclusive TruSeal technology means a strong, reliable bond every time. At SafeLite, we stand behind our work.
Night, night, little buddy.
Because the ones you love sit behind it. That's another SafeLight advantage.
SafeLight Repair, SafeLight Replace.
I may not race anymore, but I still have my own personal pit crew with me.
Blue EMU Super Strength Cream. Blue EMU gets down deep and soothes my muscles and joints. Use what I use. Blue EMU. Works fast and you won't stink.
At the Friskies Playhouse, the cats and us are always busy thinking of new ways to make treat time fun. That's how we came up with new Friskies Pull and Play. With tender string treats, cats can eat. That part was their idea. Lucy always thought string should be edible. Chloe thought the same. And Charlie, well, he's up for anything, as long as it's fun. New Friskies Pull and Play with tender strings. The whole new way to treat and play.
I'm not content to be with you in the daytime.
Yoplait, the smooth and creamy yogurt your whole family loves. Yoplait Original, with no artificial sweeteners, no artificial flavors, and no high fructose corn syrup.
Centrum brings us the biggest news in multivitamin history. A moment when something so familiar becomes something so new. Introducing new Centrum Vitamins, a multivitamin that contains a full spectrum of essential nutrients you enjoy like a mint. New Centrum Vitamins, the coolest way yet to get your multivitamins.
This kind of weather, all bets are off.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, scattered thunderstorms. High 87. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 74. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 87. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
On AM HQ.
I want to make sure everybody can get an idea of what's happening here.
Let's talk about that.
Let's lift the base of this.
You're about to see something you have never seen on television before.
Oh, look at this. It does not get much better than that. Sunrise in beautiful Breckenridge, Colorado. Kristen Pettit tells me 49 days till they open the slopes. Of course, Mother Nature, we hope, cooperates with some snow, but it's an El Nino year, and we are counting on big things. Look at this. Look at this. We're peak fall color right now. This is a ski resort that has 300 sunny days of the year. We have 350 inches a year on average, and we've gotten some huge dumps over time. And, Sam, you know how much of a tree hugger I am.
I know.
I certainly...
The king
of
tree hugging.
So, Brad, go with me here for a second. This is not an aspen, even though it's the same color as the aspen tree. Mm-hmm. But I don't know what it is, and it's killing me not to know what this is. So Brad, go in nice and tight, and if somebody at home can tweet me at Jim Cantore what this tree, maybe I don't think it's a cottonwood, but let me know, because it's just killing me not to find out this morning. Real tiny leaf, real small leaf on this one, and it's beautiful, just like many of the trees here. We are at peak fall color, and it's just awesome, Sam. You got the gorgeous mountains, the cobalt blue sky, the aspen gold. It takes your breath away. Yeah. As a matter of fact, I was 20 minutes late for the shoot yesterday because I had them stop and let me take pictures. I mean, seriously.
Let me see that tree.
Not only that,
but Jim, my entire, I mean, you were sending me, you were texting me pictures all afternoon, all evening last night. It was like pow, 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 pow. Tree, another tree, another tree.
You're like,
all
wow,
coming from
another
Jim.
Leaf. Another tree.
There's lots more to show you from Breckenridge this morning. Of course, we're live there as we say hello to the fall. Hey, let's say hello to you, Miami, this morning. And so that upper low, that mid-level low in Georgia has everything to do with our cloudy skies right now. As it kind of tightens up a little bit, we might be able to break into some sunshine, but we'll keep some storms around, particularly moving from the Gulf Coast all across the state in the afternoon and evening hours. Hey, good morning, Washington, D.C. as well. Take a look at your three-day. We've got, you'll notice a difference getting in. Now the clouds are kind of sweeping in. And as this moves up the coast, creeps up the coast, D.C. will get into the rain as well. Big picture, Jen.
Big picture, and look at all this rain that we are tracking across parts of the southeast, still even holding on to some in the Midwest, but that will be diminishing. But we look at the low across the southeast, that is going to be our big player as we go through the weekend. Let's get right to our coastal problems. We look at the low, and we do know it's right on the border of Georgia as well as in Alabama, but look at all this moisture, tropical moisture just being pumped in. The area that we're worried about for the mountains as well as the coastal regions, that's where we're going to see the heaviest rainfall. And of course, we're looking at beach erosion as well as the strong winds. We go across parts of the Midwest as well as into the plains. You can't buy fall anywhere unless you're under some clouds and rain. As we show you for our temperatures over towards the west, we have the triple digits that are going to be popping up. Arizona, Phoenix, yesterday you had 100 degrees. Today, you got 104. And then we look across parts of the Gulf. This is our next potential tropical trouble. As we show you, we have an area of low pressure that can likely develop. If it does, it would have about a 20% chance of development over the next 5 days. It's going to be moving into warm temperatures, water-wise, and then eventually dealing with some shear. Right now, we'll turn over to Anna Rennes.
Good morning, Jen. Good morning to you at home. Topping our headlines this Friday, Pope Francis is in New York this morning. The Pope is speaking at the United Nations today. His address will likely include climate change, the same topic he took up during an unprecedented address to Congress yesterday. Thousands of people turned out. Listen to this.
Our world.
Never before has a Pope stood before a joint meeting of Congress. That's why there were thousands of people inside on the Capitol steps and spilling out onto the National Mall.
These people here on the Mall are about celebrating the message that the Pope brings.
This common good also includes the earth.
Listening here at a climate change rally, we found James L. Davis.
I came here, I'm a Vietnam veteran. Although I was raised as a Protestant, the Catholic was right there for me when I was in the Army, and that's why I came. I think that he is the people's hope. Well, the good book teaches us the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof.
Words that connect millions of people all sharing this one tiny planet.
The environmental challenge we are undergoing and its human roots concern and affect us all.
You know, that's an interesting image. Both sides of the aisle standing up for an environmental message from this Pope. And it goes way beyond the fact that just John Boehner and Nancy Pelosi are both practicing Catholics. This Pope is a real uniter, even on the floor of Congress.
It's incredible to see him addressing Congress, which doesn't always connect the dots between morality and climate change.
For Pope Francis, climate change is not a political issue at all. It's a moral issue.
You know, he's got 1.2 billion Catholics in the world, and his message to those Catholics are, we have to care about the planet.
It's been an overwhelmingly positive reception for the Pope here in the United States. He's in New York today addressing the General Assembly of the UN. Then it's on to Philadelphia and back to Rome on Sunday night. In D.C. at the Capitol, I'm Dave Malkoff, The Weather Channel.
That address will happen in the next hour. We're back.
The challenges facing the country never stop. So neither does the U.S. Army. We train, adapt, and get smarter. Every soldier, every unit, every day. Not to keep up with change, but to drive it. Nobody knows what problems tomorrow will bring, but we do know who will solve them.
Neighbor, Ellie.
LED bulbs can last for over 20 years and save hundreds of dollars on your energy bill. So stop by your neighborhood Ace now and get an LED dimmable indoor reflector bonus pack with two free bulbs.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Sir, can you step aside?
Sir? Come on, you know who I am. Progressive Insurance. I save people an average of over $500 when they switch.
Did you pack your own bags?
Oh, right, the Name Your Price tool. It shows people policy options to help fit their budget. Crazy that a big shot like me would pack his own bags, right? So, do I have the right to remain handsome? Wait. Uh-oh.
Before you put any engine to bed this winter, don't drain the fuel tank. Top it off with Stabil Storage. It keeps fuel fresh. So come spring, your power equipment is ready to go. And your hog won't be a bore.
If you have moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis like me, and you're talking to a rheumatologist about a biologic, this is Humira. This is Humira, helping to relieve my pain and protect my joints from further damage. This is Humira, helping me reach for more. Doctors have been prescribing Humira for more than 10 years. Humira works for many adults. It targets and helps to block a specific source of inflammation that contributes to RA symptoms.
Humira can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis. Serious, sometimes fatal infections and cancers, including lymphoma, have happened, as have blood, liver, and nervous system problems, serious allergic reactions, and new or worsening heart failure. Before treatment, get tested for TB. Tell your doctor if you've been to areas where certain fungal infections are common, and if you've had TB, hepatitis B, are prone to infections, or have flu-like symptoms or sores. Don't start Humira if you have an infection.
Talk to your doctor and visit Humira.com. This is Humira at work.
Right on cue.
It's more than just a meal. It's Meow Mix Mealtime. With great taste and 100% complete nutrition, it's the only one cats ask for by name.
I've seen hurricanes, floods, I've seen tornadoes. We give out Duracell batteries after the worst happens. And when the power's out for days, we stay with them. You might say they lost everything, but that's not what I see. I see a different kind of power. I saw it in Ruth, Adam, Tom. It's the power they have inside of them. The power to move forward.
At Duracell, we believe that's the power that never, ever goes out.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, scattered thunderstorms, high 87, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour, chance of rain 40%. Tonight, cloudy skies, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible, low 74. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 87, chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome back to AMHQ. Did I remind you yet that it is Friday? You made it all the way through the week, but in the southeast, we have a tale of two different cities. Looking at Dallas, today it's going to be dry, sunny, highs in the lower 90s. Atlanta, you're going to go through culture shock. Today, we're going to be stuck in the clouds. We got hammered with the rainfall overnight, half inch to an inch. A lot of us, when we were driving in, we were having a tough time really just making it on the roadways because we're looking at some isolated flooding. Today in Atlanta, here comes the big story. Highs only in the mid-60s because of the rain and the clouds. So we're breaking it down for you. Dallas, 92 degrees. You're above average. And then Atlanta, you're way below average. And you notice those temperatures, 20 degrees so across parts of the south. As we move it ahead and we look and show you what's going on, we have our area low pressure. You see that circulation there? That's what's going to be causing all the problems as we go through the upcoming weekend. But our temperatures today,
15 degrees below average for Atlanta. You see the yellow contour now with that rain shield and the clouds dropping those temperatures down. And we're going to see that as we go through today. Tomorrow, we start to rebound just a touch with 70 degrees. But you notice we're still looking at those winds coming in from the east. We're going to be locked in with the rain and the clouds below average, especially right along the mountains today. You're only going to get to like the 50s, whereas areas including parts of the southern plains, you're going to soar to the 90s. We look in Dallas and here's your forecast. You're going to stay hot Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. As we go through the weekend and all the way through next week at the end of September, you're on pace for more 90s and 80s. And did you know, did it seem pretty hot this September? Well, the last time you had hotter temperatures, we're looking at back in 1910 when you had temperatures of 86 degrees or more for the entire month of September. Yeah. And look what you're going to end on.
Yeah, I know. When your big cool down is 88 degrees, you're not hitting much too cool air. All right. Hey, if you're looking for peak fall color, you may have to get to about 9,000 feet in the Colorado Rockies. And that's where we are, by the way. When you see our images today coming out of beautiful Breckenridge, Colorado, where Jim is this morning, you're going to see fall color at its peak. But Jim, it's not going to feel like fall. You're looking at potential record high temperatures today, 5 to 10 degrees above normal. And by the time we get into maybe Monday, about 20 degrees above normal.
Yeah, it's kind of wild, actually. This is a pretty late warm season for them, but the fall color's been fantastic. It's been right on schedule here. We had a wonderful spring and summer in terms of rainfall, so the trees are well-nourished, and they are putting on a show. And Sam, I know if you're like the viewers at home, you're probably going, why in the heck is that tree trunk blue? Well, we thought we'd go right to the top and get a tour of town with Mayor John Warner.
Hey, Sam and Jen, welcome to Breckenridge, Colorado. This is one of the oldest towns on the western slope of Colorado. It was established in 1859. We're known for our skiing. We get 350 inches of snow every year, 3,400 vertical feet of skiing. Average temperature is about 20 degrees here in Breckenridge. We love it here in the winter, but falls are a great time to be here as well. Hey guys, this is where I have breakfast 2-3 days a week. Great food. I have lunch here 2-3 days a week. Come here in the fall when it's crisp and cool outside. I come here in the winter when it's pretty chilly outside. This potbelly stove is fabulous. Just one of my favorite places to have a nice meal. Hey guys, I got something cool to show you. Blue trees.
So the Blue Trees Project was part of the Breckenridge International Festival of Arts, and we brought environmental artist Constantine Demopoulos, who's an Australian artist, to Breckenridge for a week in order to do the Blue Trees. And his vision for this project is to raise awareness about global deforestation.
I want to give you a great history lesson, something really cool about Breckenridge. This is what got through the weather, the snow. This is what made Breckenridge what it is. There were times when the snows, like 1899, the snows were like 8-9 feet tall. This rotary snowplow comes down the track, spins the blade, and blows the snow off the side.
The winter of 1898 and 1899 is known as the big snow year. I've heard that during that big snow year that it snowed every single day from Thanksgiving through April.
This concludes our tour of Breckenridge. We're standing on the deck of the lodge at Breckenridge. I invite you to come to Breckenridge any season. Summers are warm, they're beautiful long days. We've got great corn snow in the spring, pow in January, the middle of the winter, and perhaps one of the best views for fall colors in all of Colorado.
All right, Mayor John Warner joining us this morning. Thank you, sir. That was a great tour of town. What a beautiful place you got here.
Thanks.
This is tough being out here, isn't it? I feel sorry.
Somebody's
got
to do it.
I feel sorry. All right, so these blue trees.
You got it.
Great idea. Does this stuff go away?
It does go away. It's a soluble paint.
Okay.
And they told us 4 to 6 weeks. Well, I think it's going to be 4 to 6 months. We need some weather, snow, moisture.
We will do our best to get you some snow, sir.
Sounds great.
Thank you very much for the tour. Guys, much more to come this morning. Tell Jen Delgado that she has got to stick around for that 9 o'clock hour because we have dogs. Oh. Beautiful dogs. That is all coming up later on this morning.
Thanks.
Take a look at these barbecue trophies. Best cracked pepper sauce. Most ribs eaten while calf roping.
Yep. Greatness deserves recognition. You got any trophies, cowboy?
Well, there's this one.
Best insurance mobile app.
Yeah, 2 years in a row.
Well, I'll be. Does that thing just follow you around?
Like a little puppy.
The award-winning Geico app. Download it today.
These wings are pretty great, huh?
Yeah.
What is that?
Oh, it's a wing ring.
What's a wing ring?
I ask it what kind of wings I should have, and it tells me. Today it said honey barbecue.
Well, I want to ask it a question.
Oh, you know what? I got like 2% battery on this thing.
Well, come on, let me just...
Yeah, I wish I could.
So. You have battery in a ring?
Yeah, it's like 8 gigs.
That's two different things. One is memory and one's battery.
Cool. All I know is like, no, you can't use it.
Good luck choosing 100% all white meat boneless chicken wings in 6 delicious flavors. Or buy one, get one free every Monday night. This is how you Sonic.
Dave's been working on his game.
Morning, double bogey.
Hey, three pup.
And starting each day with a delicious bowl of heart-healthy Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
How's your cereal?
Sweet. Tastes like winning.
How would you know what winning tastes like?
Dave loves the two scoops, and that Kellogg's Raisin Bran is one more step towards a healthy tomorrow.
You eat slower than you play.
You're in a hurry to lose, huh?
Oh, okay.
Invest in your heart health with Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
No crying today.
When is your flu shot more than a flu shot? When it helps give a life-saving vaccine to a child in need in a developing country. Thanks to customers like you, Walgreens Get a Shot, Give a Shot program has helped provide 7 million vaccines. Make your flu shot make a world of difference. Walgreens, at the corner of happy and healthy.
So I heard about that new offer from AT&T and DirecTV, but they still lock you in to a 2-year contract. That could cost you over $2,600, all for temperamental satellite TV service. AT&T and DirecTV, call it a new offer. But it's just the same old thing.
Don't fall for AT&T and DirecTV's latest offer. Only Xfinity delivers the fastest internet and the best TV experience with X1.
Could the turf on our kids' playgrounds and athletic fields pose a serious health risk?
We don't feel comfortable having our kids on the field.
An NBC News investigation prompted communities across the country to take action. But opinions are divided and questions remain.
If someone brings some science forward, we will listen.
Next week, a closer look at the potential dangers and the nationwide debate over crumb rubber turf.
This is a difficult choice for communities.
A special series next week on NBC Nightly News with Lester Holt.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, scattered thunderstorms, high 87, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour, chance of rain 40%. Tonight, cloudy skies, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible, low 74. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 87, chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
This incredible video of a dust devil moving across a field. You're thinking, well, is this coming out of Arizona, Texas? No, this is coming out of Louisiana, Floyd, Louisiana, just to the northeast of Vicksburg. Mm-hmm. Well, the National Weather Service, the meteorologists who are working there out of Jackson, Mississippi, just happened to be out, and this is what they caught. Incredible. This is on the edge of a field, crossing over 577, and then it just intensified and blew up.
Yeah.
And they've been dealing with dry conditions, seeing this a lot
lately. They've been saying that, yeah, it's so dry that they've had a number of these lately all along the same road area. And if you had the volume up for a while, Jim, I know you're watching this with us because you've got a big monitor in front of you in Breckenridge. But you can hear him say, oh, look, it's counterclockwise. Uh-huh. It's just kind of cool to see it.
Yeah, I mean, you know what's interesting is you remember the water spout that we showed the other day?
Yes.
Yeah.
Which is kind of, you know, this, you know, from the same physics. But we said that was a supercell. Well, we know this comes from the bottom up. And if you notice that loop, you'll see it kind of start wide, and then as it tightens up a little bit, the debris or the dust is going a lot faster. So it's kind of like the skater,
right?
You know, spinning around, They pull in the arms and going a lot faster. And that's kind of, wow. Don't do that at 9,600
feet. Don't do that in high elevation.
But you can kind of see that.
We might lose you.
You can kind of see that.
Yeah, absolutely. Woo. Awesome stuff. You got it back together?
Jim, can you
wait? I'm all right.
Are you with us? Just hang on. Stay standing. We've got a lot to talk about. Let's really start dealing about the rain and thunderstorms that are along the coast. And Michael Lowry is going to, you know, take it from there. Go, Michael.
Good morning, Sam. Good morning to everybody at home. You know, yesterday, Sam, I had mentioned it was the 10-year anniversary of Hurricane Rita that hit southwest Louisiana, a devastating hurricane for that part of the coast. But this week also marking the 5-year anniversary for another sort of forgotten storm in the Gulf of Mexico and the Western Caribbean. That one was Tropical Storm Matthew. And a lot of people don't remember Matthew, 60-mile-per-hour tropical storm that hit Nicaragua into the Yucatan Peninsula. And it killed over 100 people. So it just goes to show you, Sam, that you don't have to have some big storm to have big impacts. And that's why we're watching the Gulf of Mexico into the Western Caribbean Sea. Today, we have two areas that we're watching. Over here, sort of off the east coast or the west coast of Mexico, this one has a high chance of development, an 80% chance of development. And I want to mention this one because it's easy to sort of overlook this with what's happening here in the Gulf. This one's going to be headed toward Mexico, and it could bring some heavy rain showers there and the potential for some flooding. So let's not forget about this. But let's focus our attention on what might come of what's happening here in the Western Caribbean. This is our 5-day development area. Notice it's in the Gulf of Mexico. It's not in the Western Caribbean because this interaction with land in the short term is going to prevent anything from developing. What we have right now is a trough of low pressure, sort of this dashed line that I'm drawing here. The winds are just broadly turning around that dashed line. This whole area of showers and storminess is going to cross the Yucatan Peninsula tomorrow into Sunday, and then we'll get an area of low pressure set up here toward the southern Gulf of Mexico come Monday. And look how quickly this kind of zips off to the north and all of that tropical moisture being pulled with it. Now, does it become a tropical depression? Does it become a tropical storm? Is it more than, can it become more than that? I think it's unlikely just because of the upper level wind pattern. We'll have this low pressure system here, but neither one of our models today is forecasting a particularly strong area of low pressure. What they are forecasting, though, are strong upper level winds. And this sort of wind pattern, when you're getting winds from the southwest to the northeast, that's just not favorable for significant development. But what it also is going to do, it's going to draw all of that tropical moisture into the northern Gulf Coast. So really anywhere from southeast Texas over the way to the Florida Panhandle, we could see some heavy rainfall come early part of next week, Monday and Tuesday. Our models are a little quicker on moving this thing, which good and bad, right? It's going to be sooner rather than later, but it means the moisture isn't going to linger as long as we thought it might, but could bring some problems there, some flooding concerns to the Florida Panhandle. And if it gets a little stronger than that, we could be talking about coastal concerns. You know, where we are talking about coastal concerns, we were mentioning this earlier this morning, is off here, off the U.S. East Coast. See this little cinnamon swirl over here? That's an upper level area of low pressure. There is a surface low just to the east of, say, Savannah, or around Savannah. And it's the difference between this low pressure and building high pressure to the north that's creating this really strong onshore flow. 23-mile-per-hour winds right now in Norfolk, Sam. So look, this weekend, as the pressure gradient tightens up, we're going to be talking about some pretty major coastal impacts, but thankfully, no named tropical system out of this.
I got to tell you, Michael, if you're looking at that thing in the Gulf, it could be the same situation for the Gulf Coast states that we're dealing with southeastern states right now. Steady wind, constant wind, a lot of extra water at high tide time. Take a live look at New Orleans this morning, and we'll say 74 degrees is 74 to 76 in the area right now. We're going to 86 today, 87 tomorrow.
AT&T and DirecTV are now one, which means you can watch movies while you're on the move, sitcoms while you sit on those, and even Fargo in Fargo. Binge while you lose weight and enjoy a good cliffhanger while you hang from a why am I yelling? The revolution will not only be televised, the revolution will be mobilized. Introducing the all-in-one plan, only from DirecTV and AT&T.
Did you know that? that meeting your daily protein needs actually helps to support your muscle health? Boost High Protein Nutritional Drink can help you get the protein you need. Each serving has 15 grams of protein to help maintain muscle, plus 26 vitamins and minerals, including calcium and vitamin D, to support strong bones. Boost High Protein is the number one selling high protein complete nutritional drink, and it has a great taste, guaranteed. Help get the nutrition you need every day with Boost High Protein.
Available at these fine retailers.
Andrew, Rita, Sandy. Meet Chris, Jackie, Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
When your windshield needs fixed, trust Safelite. For these parents, driving around was the only way to get their baby to sleep. So when their windshield got cracked,
we can't drive this car.
They wanted it fixed right. So they scheduled with Safelite. Our exclusive TruSeal technology means a strong, reliable bond every time. At Safelite, we stand behind our work.
Night-night, little buddy.
Because the ones you love sit behind it. That's another Safelite advantage.
Safelite repair, Safelite replace.
Hurry in, buy one, take one is back. Tonight, enjoy breadsticks, salad, and your choice of entrees, like smoked mozzarella chicken. Then take home another entree for tomorrow free. It's two delicious nights of togetherness. Buy one, take one, starting at $12.99 at Olive Garden.
I've got two reasons to take care of my heart. That's why I take Meta.
Meta is clinically proven to help lower cholesterol. Try Meta today. And for a tasty, heart-healthy snack, try a Meta Health Bar.
Let's do some fancy footwork. Tap into new territory with style. Step up the savings and learn some new moves. Yeah, let's tango. Here, here, even here. Then, let's take a bow. Let's do this. Get durable, beautiful Pergo Haley Oak Laminate for just $229 a square foot. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
Hey, McMillan, you gelling?
I'm gelling and Zinfandelin, and so is my new bride, Ellen McMillan.
I'm so happy my eyes are welling.
Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are so soft, they make your feet feel outrageously comfortable.
I'm gelling.
You're so not gelling.
Dr. Scholl's.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, scattered thunderstorms, high 87, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour, chance of rain 40%. Tonight, cloudy skies, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible, low 74. Saturday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 87, chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.